Ladies and gentlemen, meet Sonny Winkler, a four-time All-Conference USA, two-time All-American offensive lineman from Middle Tennessee State. After going undrafted in the NFL and declining several offers from the Canadian Football League, the rumor mill has it that he has decided to hang up the cleats and put on the visor. I'm getting reports that he has actually accepted an offensive coordinating job in Conference USA, and he is actually scheduled to make a statement at 12:30 p.m. Eastern Time, where I imagine we will hear where he is going to coach. After receiving offers from Rice, Tulsa, Marshall, and Middle Tennessee State, Sonny Winkler is coming home. He's going to be the new offensive coordinator for the Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders. The team went 8-4 last year. Look for them to improve when they get at least a 10-win season and win a bowl game. After seeing Middle Tennessee State's schedule, the biggest game being BYU, I'm going to open this up to the viewers. Go ahead and comment which team you'd like to see me play here. Granted, this is going to be on Heisman. I do like to think I'm pretty good, but we want to give Sonny Winkler a good first year so that we can maybe see if we get some good head coaching jobs in the coaching carousel at the end of the year. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to your Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders home opener versus the Kent State Golden Flashes. Debuting in his first game as offensive coordinator, it's Sonny Winkler. And let me tell you, the first half went exactly as planned. They blasted off to a 28-0 lead on the back of Van Collins. He went 21 of 30 for 483 yards, 6 touchdowns, and an interception. They ended up coasting to a 42-3 lead after the starters came out in the third quarter. George Patterson, senior tight end, ended up with 4 catches for 148 yards and 2 touchdowns, and the big highlight reel play of the game where he stiff-armed that dude into the end zone. Middle Tennessee State starts the season 1-0 as they look to keep the momentum up next week in a tougher matchup versus the North Carolina Tar Heels. Stay tuned for next week's game. Ladies and gentlemen, if you woke up with a half-open can of Keystone Light in your hand while North Carolina's film plays in the background, you'd be Sonny Winkler, the offensive coordinator for the number one passing team in Division I football. Big game today for the Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders going up against a Power 5 school in North Carolina. Former home, the greatest of all time, Mitch Trubisky. Bill, that was supposed to say Michael Jordan.
Hey, fuck you, Jim!
Okay, all right. Middle Tennessee State jumped out to a 21-7 lead in the first half, but Van Collins, doing his best Mitch Trubisky impression, threw 18 of 50 with 4 interceptions and a lost fumble. Joe Burrow can sleep well tonight knowing that at least he doesn't have Middle Tennessee State's offensive line, as Van Collins was sacked 4 times, including that strip sack. With only 2 broken clipboards throughout the game, offensive coordinator Sonny Winkler will start 1-1 after the 34-21 loss to North Carolina. Next week's game is at number 13, Texas. Bill, did you schedule that? Ladies and gentlemen, if you were wheeled out of an Outback Steakhouse in Austin, Texas last night, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Winkler in a David vs. Goliath matchup versus the nationally ranked Texas Longhorns. The Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders got off to a Jimmy John's freaky fast start as they took a 24-7 lead in the halftime. Van Collins was rocking and rolling like his Uncle Phil. After week 3, he leads the nation in passing yards, touchdowns, and interceptions. Bill, did you know that Van was related to Phil Collins?
I don't like watermelons.
Bill, get Bill out of here. Van connected with Steve Williams on an ill-advised deep ball and was able to give the defender a reach around for the Who lets Bill write these? Sonny Winkler's offense controls the ball in the second half with the help from sophomore running back Damon Young, who had 17 carries for 97 yards. The upset is complete with Middle Tennessee 44, Texas 21. Bill, you motherfucker! Breaking news, the starting running back Damon Young has torn his shoulder on the very first play of the conference opener versus Florida Atlantic.
I heard he got attacked by a mountain lion.
A mountain lion, Bill, in Florida? Damon Young is going to be out for 8 weeks. Look for him to return conference championship weekend. Now, Bill, come back here so you can go shoulder deep into my ass. If you spent the night in an Orlando strip club, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Winkler. With starting running back Damon Young out, backup running back Fred Chambers really released the dump truck as he had FAU drinking his bathwater, racking up a total of 254 yards on 17 carries. Late in the third quarter, down a score, Van Collins was able to throw a couple of touchdowns sprinkled in between his regularly scheduled interceptions. Middle Tennessee State, 41, FAU, 31. Next week, If you can't come within 300 feet of a Chick-fil-A in the Midwest region, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Wrinkler. The 3-1 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders hosting a formidable opponent in the once nationally ranked Boise State Broncos. The Broncos galloped to a massive lead well into the second quarter, up 24-3 over our Blue Raiders. Van Collins connected with 6th-string wide receiver Paul Ramsey, who Sonny Wrinkler just got in the transfer from Tennessee State Penitentiary. Ramsey caught 2 passes for 2 touchdowns and scared some local children. Backup running back Fred the Dump Truck Chambers dropped another massive load with 15 carries for 232 yards and a touchdown. Late in the fourth, down 10, on back-to-back drives, Van Collins unleashed a couple of usually intercepted long balls that connected for a couple of scores to boost Middle Tennessee to a victory over the Broncos, 38-34. Look for them to ride this high long and hard in the next week's game against Eastern Carolina. Hey, Bill, want to go smoke some?
You spent more money on lottery tickets than recruiting offensive linemen, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Wrinkler. The 4-1 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders hosting the measly Eastern Carolina Pirates. Van Collins must have had one too many Red Lobster biscuits last night, as he threw not one, not two, not three, but 5 interceptions early in this game. Andy Sanders and George Patterson wrangled in a couple of his errantly thrown balls late in the game to stave off a late-game comeback from the Pirates. Middle Tennessee State 42, Eastern Carolina 35. Now over to Bill for a breakdown play of the game. The fuck you, Jim! He threw another pit. I don't know why I fucking worked.
If you go to the movie theaters just buy popcorn and leave, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Wrinkler. The 5-1 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are on the road against 2-3 conference opponent North Texas Mean Green. Van Collins, to no one's surprise, struggled in the air today, so he expedited it via ground delivery. His 40 time was clocked at about 5.2, so expect him to get in there in 2-3 business days. Injured star running back Damon Young, bet backup running back Fred the Dump Truck Chambers if he can hurdle a defender in today's game. He's airborne! Yeah, he's hurt. Yeah, he's definitely hurt. Today's play of the game goes to backup quarterback Daniel Moore. With the Blue Raiders up 32, Moore was able to escape the pocket, juking the life out of this poor man. Then was able to break the laws of physics, throwing across his body for a 43-yard reception. The Blue Raiders go on to curb stomp the North Texas Mean Green, 49-10. The Blue Raiders are off next week with a bye. Hey, Bill, quick question. Have you ever Google searched Blue Eye?
If you are on the no-fly list due to a tropical Skittles-related incident, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Wrinkler. The 6-1 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders coming off a bye week by hosting the 3-3 Marshall Thundering Herd. Quarterback Van Collins must not be able to identify what a herd is as he continued to throw the ball into a herd of defenders, throwing 5 interceptions for the second time this year, bringing his total to 22 through 8 games. With Marshall leading for most of the game at the end of the third quarter, Van Collins makes a Nathan Peterman type read, throwing right at the defender.
Oh, wait, what? That guy's gonna get cut.
Down 7, late in the fourth. The fans are already leaving due to Van Collins' anticipated 6th interception. He throws a Sonny Wrinkler dime to the corner of the end zone to force overtime. Fast forward to the 3rd overtime, where when you score, you must go for 2. Well, the Thundering Herd fought a tough game, but must have been constipated as they were unable to convert the 2. Final score, Middle Tennessee 50, Marshall 48. If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Wrinkler. The 7-1 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in Birmingham, Alabama, visiting the 4-3 UAB Blazers. The offensive coordinator Sonny Wrinkler was ejected from the game after telling the female referee to get off her knee. She's blowing the game, as this interception clearly bounced right off the ground but was upheld after the challenge. Hopefully Van Collins can shake it off, because it really wasn't his fault. Nope, that's a pick. He's going back to the house. With that pick 6, UAB took a 41-34 lead late into the third quarter. However, the rest of the game belonged to the Blue Raiders as they outscored the Blazers 24-7 down the final stretch. With this 65-48 victory, Middle Tennessee could crack the top 25 as they came into this game 29th in the power rankings. Next week is home versus the 6-2 FIU Panthers.
Hey, Bill, is that your mom?
MILF. If you've banked up over 125,000 tickets at Dave & Buster's, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Wrinkler. Ladies and gentlemen, your Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are officially ranked. Now they just need to go out there and prove that they are the 25th best team in the nation, and that's a pick. Mother Down 10, Van Collins is able to shake off the interception as he hits Steven Williams, who is more open than your girlfriend's legs on OnlyFans. He takes it 57 yards for the score. FIU 10, Middle Tennessee 7. The very Caucasian George Patterson is able to verify that white man can jump, but he is unable to score. The Blue Raiders rally around the broken stereotype. Late in the fourth, the backups are in except wide receiver Andy Sanders, who promised a young dying boy that Middle Tennessee would drop a 50-burger. He mosses the defender. He makes one miss. No, he's leveled at the one. Middle Tennessee, 48. FIU, 27. Bill is now notifying me that the young boy has died. If you can only drink Arizona iced tea out of the gallon, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Wrinkler. The 9-1, 22nd-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are visiting the 2-8 Southern Miss Golden Eagles. We start the game off with a 51-yard bomb to wide receiver Matt Fuller to take the lead, but more importantly, the nation needs to be aware of the only player in the country with bigger hips than a Pixar mom. It's Fred, the dump truck Chambers. For a 72-yard touchdown, the defense must love watching him leave.
I know I do.
What?
Even though the defenders literally blend in with the end zone, Van Collins is able to thread the needle to Martin Miller, and the Blue Raiders never looked back. Which is ironic, because Van never really looks when he throws, either. As he blindly lobs one up to Steve Williams, who ends up making him look good once again. Final score, Middle Tennessee 49, Southern Miss 24.
Bill, I just realized no one in the stands is wearing a mask.
If your pregame hype-up music is Mumford & Sons, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Wrinkler. The 10-1, 21st-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are hosting the 5-6 UTEP Miners. We are getting reports that before the game, Sonny Wrinkler called Van Collins a baby back. After crying for 15 minutes and sorting some G Fuel, Van Collins only had two things on his mind: pound the run game and pound Sonny's mom, Bertha. Van Collins was unable to be located after the third quarter. This game was never close as the second unit played the entire fourth quarter. Backup quarterback Daniel throws the ball across his body. Moore came in to shove the 50-burger down the Miners' throats, hitting Martin Miller over the middle for the final score.
I hope he bought them dinner first.
Middle Tennessee 56, UTEP 24. Regardless of a win or loss, the Blue Raiders will be facing off against Tulsa in the conference championship.
Hey Bill, you know what Tulsa is spelled backwards?
A slut! If you're coaching the Conference USA championship game, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Wrinkler. The 11-1, 12th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders taking on the 9-3 Tulsa Golden Hurricanes. Ladies and gentlemen, on his first play back, after tearing his shoulder, Damon Young rips off a huge 76-yard gain to kickstart the Blue Raiders' offense. George, the tax evasion Caucasian Patterson, catches one up the seam for the score. This game was finished quicker than Deshaun Watson in a massage parlor.
Well, without the assault.
As the defense held the Hurricanes at bay, keeping them to 7 points in the first half. They had that Gatorade bucket of Arizona iced tea ready in the fourth quarter because this game was out of reach early. Middle Tennessee rolls to a 52-27 victory, winning their first ever Conference USA championships. We take a look at the standings after the game, and Middle Tennessee sits at 12th. What bowl will they play in? Who will they play? Wrong answers only. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the bowl game announcement ceremonies. First, we take a look at the national awards. Quarterback from NIU has won the Heisman. Van Collins' 38 interceptions probably helped that. Although he didn't win the Heisman, he did win the Davey O'Brien Award. Tight end George the Caucasian Patterson won the John Mackey Award, also a Caucasian. And there we have it. The 12th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are facing off against the number 9 Oklahoma Sooners in the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. Ah, shit. If you brought salsa to the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Wrinkler. The 12th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders facing their toughest opponent of the year, the Oklahoma Sooners. Down 14 early, there's nothing holy about this Hail Mary as Van Collins rips through Oklahoma like a tornado.
He's kind of slow, though.
22 seconds left in the first half. Wide receiver Andy Sanders makes a play that he will always remember.
Until the CTE kicks in.
He takes it 75 yards for the score, which means we are going into halftime more knotted up than an Oklahomian and their cousin. 28-28. After audibling Williams to a vertical, Van Collins is able to hit the tax evasion Caucasian for the score to take the Blue Raiders' first lead of the game. Knotted up at 49 late, senior quarterback Van Collins is able to take it himself. He goes up, he goes over for the score. Middle Tennessee 56, Oklahoma 49. The Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders have beaten the heavily favored Oklahoma Sooners. After winning the Fiesta Bowl, all the reporters had one question. Will Sonny leave or will he stay? If you know how many licks it takes to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop, then you must be offensive coordinator Sonny Wrinkler. After not even receiving interviews for the job at Auburn, Tennessee, West Virginia, or even Minnesota, only two teams offered a head coaching position. His former team, the Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders, and the Rutgers Scarlet Knights.
signing a one-year deal, Sonny Wrinkler is the new head coach for the Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders.
I did not recruit at all.
If you scheduled Auburn because they did an interview for the head coaching job, then you must be head coach, Sonny Wrinkler. The Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in Auburn, Alabama, playing the Auburn University War Eagles. With the Van Collins era gone, Martin Griggs takes the helm of the team, hitting tight end Herschel Perkins, who is one biscuit away from being an offensive lineman. Down 7, Sonny Wrinkler digs deep into his Dorito bag full of tricks with his triple option to tie the game, 14-14. With Fred the Dump Truck Chambers in, he dials up the option again. No, the dump truck is down! The dump truck is down! No, he scoops! Auburn goes up by 5 after the failed two-point conversion.
Some Sonny's Wrinkler screen time.
After bleeding the clock, Damon Young is literally able to stumble into the end zone. After the two-point conversion, the defense is able to hold. Final score, Middle Tennessee 29, Auburn 26.
Hey, did Bill get fired?
If you slept with Kay Johnston's wife, then you must be head coach, Sonny Wrinkler. In a Fiesta Bowl rematch, we have the Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders visiting the 11th Oklahoma Sooners. Even though Milton Griggs reads defenses at a second grade level, he's able to hit veteran wide receiver Andy Sanders for the 87-yard score. Middle Tennessee 7, Oklahoma 13. At the goal line, Sonny dials up a triple option, and Griggs is able to take it himself for the score. And his reward is he gets touched by Sonny Wrinkler. Ah! Forget about Griggs' 4 interceptions, as he is able to connect with Herschel, I only eat chicken skins, Perkins. Middle Tennessee 22, Oklahoma 16. Following an Oklahoma touchdown, Middle Tennessee is down 4. On 4th down with 6 seconds to go, Sonny Wrinkler calls a play action. He's got Jason Washington in the flat. He catches it. No! He drops it! Oklahoma 26, Middle Tennessee 22. Oh my gosh.
Jason Washington has been benched.
If you know all the words to Taylor Swift's Fearless album, then you must be head coach, Sonny Wrinkler. This one is personal, as North Carolina was Middle Tennessee's only loss last season. On the first play from scrimmage, Andy Sanders saved what would look like another Griggs interception. He's able to take it 78 yards, and what a way to honor North Carolina great Mitch Trubisky. Middle Tennessee would extend their lead as Milton Griggs scrambles and then proceeds to throw his lifeless body over the defenders for the score. Only up 7, Hans, the only black German I know king, runs a gorgeous slant for the score. After leaving behind the Tar Heels like Roy Williams, the second unit is likely just to run the clock out here. Fuck that, baby! It's Sonny Wrinkler! We're gonna throw the long ball! Connected for a deep one here! Freshman quarterback Chris Yates is then able to provide the Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders with a 50-burger! Middle Tennessee 56, North Carolina 31. If you go to Costco just to eat the samples, then you must be head coach, Sonny Wrinkler! The 2-1 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are visiting the 24th-ranked Washington Huskies. Story of the game belongs to Milton Griggs, who must have been too afraid of Bigfoot to even open his eyes as he threw interception after interception after interception. Holy fuck. After being down 21-7, Sonny Wrinkler was forced to bench the star quarterback for 19-year-old quarterback Chris Yates. And boy, did Chris come in ready to pound some minor ass. Sorry, major ass. No minors here. The quarterback was able to hit Chicken Skins Perkins in the back of the end zone here for the score. The Washington Huskies coverage breaks down here as German wide receiver Hans King is wide open, and I haven't seen a German run that fast since World War II. Middle Tennessee 28, Washington 28. Up 1, late in the 4th, Yates puts the nail in the coffin with his 5th passing touchdown of the game. Middle Tennessee 42, Washington 34. Is there a quarter? If you can stop the gas pump at double zeros every single time, then you must be head coach, Sonny Wrinkler. Our sideline reporter has told us that freshman quarterback Chris Yates will get the start today. The Blue Raiders were flagged early, and Sonny Wrinkler had to tell the ref that his mom is a hoe. The game-opening drive finished with an Andy Sanders touchdown. And by God, it's official. Nobody can lay a finger on Chicken Skins Perkins and his 280-pound frame. Following a tightly contested first quarter, Sonny Wrinkler dials up the play action, and freshman Chris Yates is able to deliver a dagger to the German Night King for the 55-yard touchdown. Ironically enough, Fred the Dump Truck Chambers has pulled his groin. With no minors around, Chris the Predator Yates was forced to attack the Mean Greens defense instead as he threw a total 6 touchdowns in today's ballgame. The second unit came in early, but Sonny Wrinkler's offense just cannot be slowed down as this is now back-to-back 50 burgers for the Blue Raiders. Middle Tennessee 56, North Texas 20.
If you can watch Toy Story 3 and not cry, then you must be head coach Sonny Rankler. The 4-1 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are visiting the 1-3 East Carolina Pirates. Down 7 in the red zone, Yates fires a piss missile for the touchdown. Still behind early in the second half, with Yates looking for something to stretch the defense with. He's got someone down the middle. It's Chicken Skins Perkins! Look at the big fellow run! Someone must have asked him to take his shirt off at the pool! Ladies and gentlemen, we might have a Sonny Rankler shootout! The two offenses dueled it out as the defenses played hide the banana in the locker room. When the Blue Raiders are in trouble, they often look for Andy motherfucking Sanders! Middle Tennessee 46, East Carolina 38. You know the game is over when the goal line triple option is dialed up. And you can put this game in the books. That's back-to-back-to-back 50 burgers. Final score, Middle Tennessee 58, East Carolina 44. If you haven't filed your taxes since the late 90s, then you must be head coach Sonny Rankler. The 5-1 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are hosting the 2-4 FAU Owls. Well, Hogwarts must have kept them a bit later than usual because the FAU defense was nowhere to be found. Even though Chris Yates is slow as fuck and possibly a sexual predator, he does know how to sling piss missiles. Middle Tennessee was up 28-7 at half, and it is clear that nobody in Division I football has an answer for the Sonny Rankler goal line triple option. Heading into the fourth, Middle Tennessee 42-7. Wait a second, who's playing quarterback? No, wait, timeout! Who put Griggs in? After locking Griggs in a football-free zone, Yates comes back in to ensure the 50-burger. And you already know what play we're running for two. It's the goddamn triple option, baby. 50-burger number four, Middle Tennessee 50, FAU 28. If you couldn't play youth football because you were over the weight limit, then you must be head coach Sonny Rankler. The 6-1 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders visit the 3-4 UTEP Miners. Chris, the sexual predator Yates, was especially excited for this matchup against the Miners. On 4th and 2, the freshman quarterback is able to connect with senior wide receiver Brian Turner for his first catch of the year, and he's going to take it the distance, baby. Middle Tennessee 14, Miners 0. Herschel Chicken Skins Perkins is leading the nation in touchdown receptions, and it's easy to tell why, as he doesn't ask for consent when he penetrates the defense. And that's what Yates really admires about him, as he takes this ball 79 yards for the score, and the big fellow will need the oxygen tank immediately. After being up 35-0 at half, the defensive coordinator was fired immediately after the game, as the Miners scored 28 points unanswered, but the Sonny Rankler offense is able to hold them off late for the narrow victory. Middle Tennessee 42, UTEP 35. Chris Yates was found after the game near a local Chuck E. Cheese. If you're the reason there's a Do Not Molest the Alligator sign, then you must be head coach Sonny Rankler. The 7-1 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are hosting the 3-5 Southern Miss Golden Eagles. After living in Miami, Florida his whole life, this is the first time Sonny Rankler has seen snow.
He did try to snort it.
Only up 7, the Blue Raiders have the advantage with wide receiver Hans, the German Night King, who was born north of the wall. He is able to use the snow to sneak behind the defense for touchdowns on back-to-back drives. Middle Tennessee snowplows the Southern Miss defense to a 28-7 lead at halftime. The domination continues strong into the second half, with Chicken Skins Perkins breaking the single-season school reception touchdown record with 17 touchdowns. If you've been following the Sonny Rankler story, then you know what we're dialing up here on the goal line. It's the goal line triple option. The 50-burger was achieved early in the fourth quarter. The new defensive coordinator forced 4 Southern Miss turnovers, so Sonny Rankler will decide to let this one live. Middle Tennessee 65, Southern Miss 21. If you've only broken 37 clipboards this year, then you must be head coach Sonny Rankler. The 21st-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are visiting the 7-2 FIU Panthers. Chris, the Predator Yates, was less efficient than a blind man playing darts, as he only completed 31% of his passes today. The Blue Raiders were forced to get it done on the ground. Fred, the dump truck Chambers, put the team on his massive ass, scoring 3 touchdowns and racking up a season-high 210 yards. The new defensive coordinator must want to die because the Blue Raiders defense gave up 28 points in the first 3 quarters. So Sonny Rankler said, fuck it, I'll do it myself, scoring 35 points in the fourth quarter alone. Late in the fourth, after a touchdown, we must go for 2 to try to secure the 50-burger, which means an easy goal line triple option play. Let's look in. Alright, looks like he's going to have to keep it. He's going to have to pitch it. No! No! They stopped the goal line triple option! No 50-burger! Wait, one more shot. Sanders down the sideline! 50-burger! Put him up, baby! Middle Tennessee 55, FIU 35. If your wife Bertha left you for a yoga instructor, then you must be head coach
Sonny Wrinkler.
The 19th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in Huntington, West Virginia, playing the 4-6 Marshall Thundering Herd. After only rising two spots in the BCS ranking, Sonny Wrinkler has been disrespected. He's added them to his list right above the Hamburglar. After a couple of Chris Yates touchdowns and interceptions, the defensive coordinator continues to perform well. He is now coaching from the booth because coach couldn't stand to look at him. Middle Tennessee leads 21-10 at half as the Wrinkler makes sure to get a hand on all his players. On the first drive of the third quarter, Chris Yates throws his signature piss missile to Andy Sanders to extend the lead to 18 points. The Sonny Wrinkler-led offense is the number one scoring offense in the nation for a reason, averaging 47.5 points a game. The 50-burger was secured by old trusty, the goal line triple option, but Sonny was still hungry. As he takes to the air one more time, late in the fourth, he's got Andy Sanders for a touchdown. Middle Tennessee, 57, Marshall, 24. If you recruit people just by standing outside their window, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
The 18th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host the 8-3 UAB Blazers. After Chris Yates intelligently audibles to a run play, Hans, the German Night King, holds back three defenders on the end like it was Normandy Beach to spring the dump truck for the 39-yard touchdown. To reward Hans King, Sonny Wrinkler dials up the wide receiver jet sweep, and with defenders just bouncing off of him, he is able to convert for the touchdown. Middle Tennessee 17, UAB 0. With the Blue Raiders threatening once more, Chris Yates hits the best tight end in the nation, Herschel Chicken Skins Perkins. The route is on, baby. Middle Tennessee 31, UAB 3. The defensive coordinator fell asleep, and that's going to cost him his life. Only up 14 in the fourth, Fred the Dump Truck Chambers was moving like Shakira on this score. To make up for his five interceptions, Yates throws a piss missile to Brian Turner to guarantee the 50-burger. Middle Tennessee 52, UAB 31. Middle Tennessee will play Louisiana Tech for the conference championship. If you forgot Louisiana Tech was even a part of the conference, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
The 15th-ranked defending conference champions look to go back-to-back against Louisiana Tech. During a scientific study done last week, Sonny Wrinkler grows to 250% power when there's 6 or more inches of snow on the ground. That much, Sonny, can cause a grown man to faint, as this offense was firing on all cylinders, hitting deep ball after deep ball. He also figured out that you don't have to be on the goal line to run the triple option. He was very surprised. All-American Andy Sanders with the amazing block. Middle Tennessee 21, Louisiana Tech 0. To bring a little extra juice, the Wrinkler went to Tennessee State Penitentiary to bring back Paul, the convict Ramsey from last season. He was promptly arrested after the third quarter. After connecting on an easy deep ball with Chicken Skins Perkins, Ev and I had to double-check the difficulty because Louisiana Tech felt like a high school freshman team. The Blue Raiders beat Louisiana Tech by 51 points. Sonny Wrinkler gets his first trophy as a head coach. Middle Tennessee 64, Louisiana Tech 13. If you rejected an invitation to the Oscars because you didn't know who Oscar was, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
Today we'll be going through the awards, final season stats, and releasing the bowl game matchup. Quarterback from Texas A&M, who is definitely not Johnny Manziel, has won the Heisman. Chicken Skins Perkins takes home the John Mackey Award for Best Tight End. He was also named First Team All-American. Sonny Wrinkler has won Coach of the Year. He was unable to attend today. He's currently scouting the best second grader in the country. After making the freshman All-American team, we take a look at Chris Yates' stats. He threw for 4,400 yards, 52 touchdowns, and 34 interceptions. Time for the big reveal. Middle Tennessee will be returning to the Fiesta Bowl to take on number 7 Texas. Comment your final score predictions. We are fucked. If you were nowhere to be found 10 minutes before the game, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
The 14th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in the Fiesta Bowl taking on the number 7 Texas Longhorns. We have breaking news, as 10 minutes before the game, Longhorn quarterback Brian Coley was placed on IR with a broken back. Down 7 quick, they pull out the goal line triple option. He pitches it, it bounces off his helmet, fumble! It's the left tackle! That's a fucking touchdown! Locked up at 21 apiece, in fear of throwing another red zone interception, Chris Yates and his 61 speed are racing to the pylon. Unathletic hurdle, touchdown! Looking to go up 17 with the field goal. Just kidding, we don't even have a kicker on the roster. It's former starter Milton Griggs. That's a touchdown, baby! We up 21! Only up 7 in the fourth, Damon Young is able to dodge, duck, dip, dive, and dodge for the touchdown to put the final nail in the coffin. Middle Tennessee is your back-to-back Fiesta Bowl winners. When handed his trophy, the Wrinkler said, "You're welcome." Middle Tennessee 50, Texas 41. If you sued an all-you-can-eat buffet because they asked you to leave, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
After winning Coach of the Year, 11 offers rolled in from Power 5 schools across the country, but Sonny Wrinkler is going to leave the decision to the fans. From the SEC, the Auburn Tigers, Arkansas Razorbacks, Missouri Tigers, and the Vanderbilt Commodores. From the ACC, Louisville, Pittsburgh, and NC State. From the Big 12, we have Kansas State, and from the Pac-12, we have Oregon State. Possibly a return to Middle Tennessee State. I will comment each team below. The comment with the most likes will decide where Sonny Wrinkler will put on the visor for next year. If you go to Cracker Barrel just to play with the puzzle, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
After declining Auburn's offer because they passed on him last year, Sonny would like to thank all of his offers. Except for Oregon State, he literally took a shit on that one. Sonny Wrinkler signs a one-year extension! He's back, baby! He said there was unfinished business, and by that, he meant slapping on a mustache and sleeping with the Pac-12 commissioner's wife, Jeanette. Hold up. Wait a minute. He's blackmailing the commissioner. Middle Tennessee is in the Pac-12!
Oregon State has been removed.
If you like watching basketball because every team scores a 50-burger, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
Middle Tennessee is in Norman, Oklahoma, visiting the Oklahoma Sooners, who has become one of their trademark opponents. To kick off the season right, the goal line triple option allows Chris, the sexual predator Yates, to put the Blue Raiders on top. Knotted up at 7, veteran Blue Raider Andy Sanders is able to reverse cowgirl ride into the end zone for the score.
What the f*** is that smell?
It's a Chris Yates signature piss missile to his new favorite target, Charles, always tripping Griffin.
That's gotta get him drug tested.
Tied up at 35 apiece, Chris Yates drops back and throws his 5th interception of the day.
Oh, there goes Sonny's clipboard. Is anybody keeping count?
Second and goal, down 3, 21 seconds left. Chris Yates drops back. That's never good. Wait a second. Surprise piss missile. That's gonna do it. Middle Tennessee holds on to win 42-38. Great way to kick off the season. If you can watch 60 minutes in half an hour, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
The 1-0 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in the Coliseum playing the 12th-ranked USC Trojans. Down 14 quick, knowing that the Pac-12 hasn't seen the goal line triple option yet, Damon Young is able to put the Blue Raiders on the board. Down 17, with Sonny Wrinkler throwing his clipboard at the defensive coordinator, Chris Yates throws it into coverage. Whoa, what an adjustment! It's freshman walk-on wide receiver Jack Meatsack! Still behind late in the third, Yates gets hit as he's thrown. He's got an open receiver. Always tripping Griffin is able to reel it in. Without a child in sight, Chris Yates struggled to stay focused as he racked up 5 interceptions. To get him back on track, Sonny Wrinkler disclosed the location of a nearby birthday party. A newly motivated sexual predator, the sophomore quarterback slings a screaming hot piss missile to the freshman walk-on meat sack. Then, in the goal line triple option, he puts his heart and body on the line to secure the 50-burger. Middle Tennessee 50, USC 38. If your basement is full of chained-up defensive coordinators, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
The 20th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders play host to the 11th-ranked UCLA Bruins. It's youth night tonight here on campus, which means Chris Yates will be extremely stimulated and will be able to put a little more velocity on his piss missiles. Surprised that Yates can even read, he's able to carve up the cover two with his corner route, Middle Tennessee 14, UCLA 0. A quick snap, with the defense still getting set, Fred the Dump Truck Chambers gets the corner, hits the stanky leg, and he's gone for his longest run of the season. With kids cheering his name, Chris the Predator Yates whips out a massive piff missile. This game is getting out of control. Up 21, the defensive line is closing in. A bomb is thrown. He's got a streaking meat sack. Touchdown! Only giving up 7 points in 3 quarters, no clipboards were thrown in the defensive coordinator's general direction. Sonny Wrinkler will not be answering any questions regarding his 2-point conversion play for the 50-burger. Middle Tennessee 48, UCLA 14. If you can't find the boulder that everyone's talking about, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
The 15th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in Boulder, Colorado, playing the 3-0 Colorado Buffaloes. I'm sure the fans are so high that the goal line triple option looks like a Rubik's Cube.
Wait a second, where's always Trippin' Griffin?
This piss missile to the untouched meat sack is different from the rest, as Chris the Sexual Predator Yates has broken Van Collins' record for career touchdown passes with 69.
Nice.
Only up 4 after the half, due to multiple Yates interceptions, he knows better this time as he tucks and runs and gets folded like a picnic table. Wide receiver Josh Tremblay, who was voted everybody's least favorite teammate, somehow gets open on accident, and just like that, the Blue Raiders are up by 20. After dialing up a beautiful play that results in nobody being near the freshman walk-on, Jack Meatsack, we take a look at our brand new Sonny Cam. Oh, looks like he's headed out of the stadium to the nearest Chick-fil-A. But don't worry, the team stayed behind to secure the 50-burger. Middle Tennessee, 52. Colorado 17. If you can plug a USB in on the first try, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
The 4-0 12th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders made the 2,300-mile trip to play the 2-2 Stanford Cardinals. Sonny has won the toss and said, "We want the ball, we're gonna score." And unlike Matt Hasselbeck, that's exactly what they did as Chris Yates delivers a piss missile to wide receiver Willie Wallace.
Who the f*** is that?
The mighty goal line triple option is there to put the Blue Raiders up 14. They are in the perfect defense for the counter. Look, there's the whole— excuse me, what? I'm sorry, I didn't know I was playing Warzone. This defensive tackle's got f***ing aimbot. With Sonny on the phone with Activision, Chris Yates is able to find Meatsack on the edge, and he's able to bully his way into the end zone for the score. Fourth and goal, tied up at 21. Sonny elects to kick the field goal to take the lead. What are you talking about? He's no pussy. Touchdown! Fourth and 21, looking to disrespect. Meatsack goes up and snags it with the one hand. Oh my god, what is that? Yates with the piss missile to end it. Middle Tennessee, 35. Stanford, 21.
That is one terrifying mascot.
If you have a sweater vest for every day of the week, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Prinkler!
The 5-0 8th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in rainy Tallahassee playing the 20th-ranked Florida State Seminoles, who have the number 1-ranked D. The Blue Raiders are driving strong. He's got a receiver open over the middle.
Chris, dude, what was that?
After going scoreless in the first, we thank the Wrinkler. We have the goal line triple option. Blue Raiders on top, 7-3. Chris Yates promised Sonny no more red zone interceptions. Uh-oh, heads up! Sonny's clipboard came up and hit the press box. Yates drops back again and throws a touchdown that should have been intercepted. Coming back from halftime, wait, does Yates have a metal arm? Dear God, they Winter Soldiered him during halftime! Holy fuck! Let's go with a 60-yard piss missile! The fans are terrified! He can't stop throwing piss missiles and I can't stop watching! Sonny, tell him to stop, they're already dead! Oh, looks like it's over. Psych! I was wrong! It's another piss missile to a streaking meat sack for the 60-burger! Middle Tennessee wins, 63-38. If you're still banging the Pac-12 commissioner's wife, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Prinkler!
The 5th-ranked 6-0 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host the 3-2 Arizona State Sun Devils. After two first-quarter Yates interceptions, Middle Tennessee finds himself down 14 to a f***ing party school. Tight end Dustin Bolin is able to make a great play over the middle, but I just want him to know that he will never be Chicken Skins Perkins. Down 28-7, Sonny Wrinkler has taken the defensive coordinator to the shed out back, and I think we all know what that means. Chris Yates delivers a dime to freshman walk-on Jack Meatsack, who's able to drag his Meatsack the distance for the score. Still can't believe he's not scholarshiped yet. Surprise piss missile! Middle Tennessee cuts the lead to 6. He follows that up by delivering a perfect ball to Blue Raider veteran Andy Sanders to tie up the ballgame. The never-failing goal-line triple option pushes the lead up to 11. Chris, the sexual predator Yates, is able to sneak a ball to the back of the end zone to a tiptoeing Meatsack to secure the 50-burger. Middle Tennessee, 55. Arizona State, 37. If Super Size Me is your favorite film, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Prinkler!
The 7-0 4th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host the 17th-ranked 3-3 Oregon Ducks. It's senior night tonight, so we honor veteran wide receiver Andy Sanders and running back Fred the Dump Truck Chambers. Andy Sanders comes out of the closet to say the old man still got it on this 42-yard red rocket to put Middle Tennessee up 13-0. Quarterback Chris Yates drops back and hits freshman walk-on wide receiver Jack Meatsack for the score. He leads the nation in touchdowns and yards, but still no scholarship. Chris Yates found his arch nemesis today, a defensive back named Pickens, who picked him off twice today. Andy Sanders just absolutely loved catching long balls in the mouth. I meant end zone. Middle Tennessee, 27, Oregon, 14. Both seniors had a massive day, but not as big as Fred's dump truck. He had 313 yards on 27 carries and 2 touchdowns. Middle Tennessee holds on to win, 34-26.
Bill, did you say Chris Yates is dating a freshman?
No. You scheduled a midseason tune-up game, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Prinkler!
The 3rd-ranked 8-0 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host FCS West. They don't have a team name or an official record. Let's call this game what it was. It was a stat patter, a record breaker. The Blue Raiders broke 4 school records and 1 national during the course of this game. Since FCS West isn't a real school, we spoke with the head coach of the team and specifically asked him, where do you get your players from? His response? Mostly off the side of I-70. Chris Yates went the f*** off and broke 3 records. Career passing records with 8,000. Passing yards in 1 game, he ended up with 849. Touchdowns in a single game with 9. He still threw 3 picks. Middle Tennessee unlocks a new type of burger, the 70 burger. This one's got cheese. Freshman walk-on wide receiver Jack Meatsack ended up with 13 catches, 385 yards, and 2 touchdowns. Still no scholarship. If you have your own parking spot at the local Denny's, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Prinkler!
The 3rd-ranked 9-0 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host the 5-4 Washington Huskies. Sonny Wrinkler informing Chris the Predator Yates, no more youth camps if he keeps throwing picks. Dialing up the play action, he's got some options open, and he throws it to the defensive tackle. Whoa, double clipboard throw. The Blue Raiders find themselves an upset alert, down 21-7 to the Huskies. Yates could really use an easy one to get his confidence back. It's Meatsack, and there's nobody within 30 yards. He's just going to strut that sack into the end zone. 4th and 18, we've got a surprise piss missile to the highest player on the team. The dump truck is able to follow his blockers for 6. Middle Tennessee, 35. Washington, 35. with the fans anticipating his fifth interception. Wait, we got meat sack dragging across the face of the defense. That's a tie ball game. We're going to overtime. Here's the triple option. Whoa, that hole is wider than the Pac-12 commissioner's wife. All we need is a stop here to end this ball game. He throws. That's an interception. Woo! So that's how that feels. Middle Tennessee, 49, Washington, 42.
If you sold the punter for a box of goldfish, then you must be head coach.
Sonny, Prinkler.
The 10-0 third-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders took the bus 1,800 miles to Pullman, Washington to play the 5-5 Washington State Cougars. After being held scoreless in the first, the dump truck is able to pave the way to put the Blue Raiders on the board. Following a wazoo turnover, the dump truck takes his badonkadonk around the edge. Middle Tennessee, 14, Washington State, 3. After scoring on two run plays, they dial up the play action, and they bit harder than when Sonny first laid eyes on Bacon, and this game could possibly get out of hand early. Nobody, and I said nobody, in the nation runs a better corner than Middle Tennessee veteran Andy Sanders. We need to cherish him before he's gone. Yates is feeling himself right now. He's got Meatsack all alone deep downfield, and that touchdown was easier than Monica Lewinsky. Up 42-17, Yates slings a hot and ready piff missile to the tight end who wishes he was Chicken Skins Perkins. No clipboards were thrown today. Sonny forgot to bring them. Middle Tennessee secures a 50-burger with the goal line triple option, and they end up winning 57-31. If you're under investigation for several missing defensive coordinators, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
The third-ranked 11-0 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders travel across the country to play the 7-4 Cal Golden Bears. After the first quarter, we are tied up at zero. Sonny did not forget his clipboards this week. Yates fires a red zone piss missile to an untouched meat sack to take the lead 7-0 over the Golden Bears. The world-famous goal line triple option produces a second touchdown, and the California fans are already starting to leave. The Predator drops back. He scans the field, finds a running back in the flat, and the fans are already coming back. Whoa! That had to have been at least 30 clipboards. This pick is coming all the way back to the house. Down 7, with 36 seconds left, Yates has been benched already for obvious reasons. Griggs is able to tie up the game. Wait a second, what's this? They're going for the win. Griggs keeps it. He pitches it. They convert. Middle Tennessee will be able to escape with a W. Fuck!
Sonny will not be answering any questions at this time.
If you just want back-to-back Coach of the Year, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
The number 8 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host the USC Trojans for the Pac-12 Championship. The commissioner did not attend. The ground game was phenomenal today as the O-line got great penetration, something the commissioner's wife knows a lot about. Frederick, the dump truck Chambers, put that free safety in a blender all game long. He must have enjoyed the view of the dumpy. Middle Tennessee 14, USC 0. Knotted up at 14, Yates digs deep and delivers a special championship edition piss missile! Blue Raiders back on top! Off of the triple option, who knew that dump trucks had such good vision, Frederick is making his dad, Larry the semi-truck, a proud father. What you are about to witness is veteran wide receiver Andy Sanders' last touchdown in this stadium.
We love you, man.
Enjoy the retirement home, but that's gonna do it! Middle Tennessee State is headed to the Rose Bowl, their first year in the conference, and Middle Tennessee will bring home the chip.
Oh, hey, look, the commissioner showed up.
Middle Tennessee 42, USC 35. If you think Nebraska is a bunch of frauds, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler.
The 12-1 5th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in Pasadena, California, playing the 9-4 11th-ranked Cornhuskers. First drive needs to be a good one. We should have Meatsack over the middle. I predict a piss missile. Here it comes. Damn it, Yates! This is why child abuse exists. World-famous goal line triple option for the score. We're tied up at 7. Driving deep into Nebraska territory, looking to do some damage, and that damage was just done to 65 clipboards. Blue Raiders looking to score. Meatsack open on the slant. Fuck! God damn it! Middle Tennessee down 26-7 going into halftime. Sonny is already out of clipboards, and he brought 300. After Yates got benched for obvious reasons, Milton Griggs comes in, and he's going to be able to find a streaking Meatsack. Can Griggs bring us back for the best comeback in the history of the Rose Bowl? We are down 40-21. No, he cannot. Middle Tennessee gets a taste of their own medicine as they get their back door kicked in. Middle Tennessee 21, Nebraska 57.
Hey there, Sonny, what's it like in Tennessee? Yates is 3 inches away, but look, tonight he said you're so pretty, he likes the view. Chick-fil-A can't be the same without you, I swear it's true. Hey there, Sonny, don't you worry about the natty. I know your mouth gets a little foamy when we see that meat sack glisten. Don't close your eyes. Listen to my voice, let's get some fries. We can supersize. Oh, it's Middle Tennessee. Oh, it's Middle Tennessee. Oh, it's Middle Tennessee. Radio, it's Middle Tennessee, Middle Tennessee.
You've missed Middle Tennessee State football, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
Returning as head coach of the Blue Raiders, Sonny made sure to schedule number 5 Nebraska for an immediate Rose Bowl rematch. We kicked the season off with the goal line triple option to show the world Sonny's back. Bill, let's take a minute to talk about the new freshman tight end. His story is just so inspirational. 30 minutes after the Rose Bowl loss, a young 6'5", 300-pound African-American fella just shows up on campus with a piece of paper taped to his chest that said, I play football. Next thing you know, he's changed his name to Sonny Wrinkler Jr. Up 7 late, looking to extend the lead with the goal line triple option. Chris Yates fumbles! Chris Yates usually never lets any ball slip through his fingers. We're headed to overtime. Yates made up for it by slinging an overtime edition Biff missile to wide receiver William Cheeks. After a defensive stop, Middle Tennessee just needs to score. He's got a lane. That's going to do it. Middle Tennessee gets the revenge. Down go the Cornhuskers. Final score after double overtime, Middle Tennessee 48, Nebraska 42. You hated Remember the Titans because there weren't any 50 burgers. Then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler.
The 1-0 21st ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders visit Oklahoma for part 4 of this storied rivalry. You blink and Middle Tennessee's down 14, but Dirk Diggler digs his way into the end zone. Looking to tie the game, Chris Yates is looking, finds a familiar friend. It's All-American sophomore walk-on, Jack Meatsack. The shootout continues with Chris Yates on the read option, showing the little athleticism he actually has. Middle Tennessee has officially been put on upset alert, down 14, headed to the fourth. After Yates located a youth group, he's able to power up a piff missile to white-ass Tim Atkins, cutting the lead down to 7. Goal line option from 7 yards out, handed off to Dirk Diggler. He sees the end zone. He's got it. We've got a tie ball game. 35-35, 24 seconds left of the game. Yates drops back, which could be dangerous for everybody. 69's open over the middle. Sonny's newly found son calls game. Middle Tennessee takes a 3-1 lead over the Sooners in the series. Middle Tennessee 42, Oklahoma 35. You switch to the ACC for their commissioner's wife, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler.
The 2-0 14th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host number 8, Georgia Tech. Under Sonny Wrinkler, Middle Tennessee has never lost a home game. Look for the Blue Raiders to coast to an easy win today. That might not age too well, but surprise piss missile to the All-American sophomore walk-on, Jack Meatsack. Yates is threatening again. The defense is coming. He needs to get rid of it. He sneaks into the freshman Dirk Diggler for the easy score. Down 14. Time running out in the first half. Who else but the walk-on? Is he back? Does he deserve a scholarship? The triple option is dialed up. Yates pitches it to the practice squad star, Black John Smith, and he's going to score. This game's tied up. Don't fix what isn't broken. The triple option again. Say goodbye to the practice squad. Let's welcome Black John Smith to the team. He's going to get a full ride. We're in overtime following a Georgia Tech field goal. Dirk Diggler on the counter. Can he get to the pylon? Can he do it? He can. Middle Tennessee wins in dramatic fashion, 41. If you consider Duke a midseason tune-up game, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler.
The 3-0 10th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders visit the basketball powerhouse, the Duke Blue Devils. Duke University is hosting a youth night for the youngins here in the local city of Durham. Oh no, Chris the Predator Yates is reaching his final form. Back-to-back piss missiles, Duke is in trouble. Oh my god, it's a 70-yard piss missile to a streaking Jack Meatsack. He's praying there's a scholarship in the end zone, but there isn't. Middle Tennessee is leading Duke 42-24 due to Yates' throbbing right arm. Surprise piss missile to start the second half. Chris the Predator Yates is forcing himself down Duke's throat like they just won the prom queen. Even white-ass Tim Atkins is getting some goddamn touches. I can't fit all these touchdowns here in only 1 minute. It's pandemonium. The children are being evacuated for their own safety as Chris the Predator Yates becomes a threat to national security. Middle Tennessee is going to drop a 90 burger. This one's got all the toppings. Middle Tennessee 93, Duke 38. If you have no idea what the f*** a Demon Deacon is, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
The 4-0 5th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders visit the 0-4 Wake Forest Demon Deacons. Chris Yates on the triple option. Oh, he broke his neck! But he still finds a way into the end zone. Now that's grit! Down 3. The offense needs a jolt of energy, and who better than the cheek-clapping specialist William Cheeks III for the 47-yard score! Middle Tennessee 14, Wake Forest 7. Chris Yates drops back. He scanned the field for his favorite white boy. There he is! White-ass Tim Atkins! Whoa! He sheds off a couple defenders! Does he deserve to start? Wait a second, who's that in the slot? It's backup quarterback Milton Griggs! He catches it in traffic! What? Need one more score for the 50 burger. Someone's open in the corner! It's Milton Griggs again! What the f*** is going on out there? Triple option for the 60 burger. That's why Black John Smith has a full ride scholarship! Middle Tennessee blows Wake Forest out of the water, 62-30. If they call you instead of the Ghostbusters, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler.
The 5-0 5th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in Tallahassee taking on the 13th-ranked Florida State Seminoles. Down early per usual, but the world-renowned goal-line triple option puts the Blue Raiders on the board. Florida State's having a pretty good year so far, but on this play, they're going to get their cheeks clapped by William Cheeks III. What a deep ball from the Heisman candidate slash sexual predator. Goal line triple option, but not on the goal line. The pitch is to the Black John Smith, and dear Lord, he's craftier than a box of Kraft mac and cheese. Middle Tennessee 21, Florida State 6. Yates is playing I Spy, and he spies a piss missile to Sonny's long-lost black son. Time running out in the first half. Yates digs deep, and he's got someone on the sideline. I've never seen cheeks this spread out before. Touchdown! Late in the fourth, up 20. Yates can't find anybody. He's going to tuck it. He's going to run. He makes one miss. He's going to fumble. So pick it up. It's meat sack. Middle Tennessee drives the Seminoles off their land 42-29. If you try to recruit Air Bud, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler.
The 6-0 4th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are hosting the 5-1 11th-ranked Clemson Tigers. Penetrating the red zone early, just like Yates likes it, he finds a quarterback-turned-wide receiver, Milton Griggs. What a great set of hands. Yates is being very patient in the pocket. He must be distracted. Wait, it's a no-look piss missile to the cheeks-clapping specialist. This game is getting out of hand early. Black John Smith around the edge, and he's going to cut right back in just to posterize him. They need to call this game before it gets ugly. Up 25 in the red zone, Yates finds the All-American sophomore walk-on, Jack Meatsack. 50 seconds left in the game. Chris Yates takes a 7-step drop, looking to go balls deep. He's got a streaking meat sack. That's going to be the 50-burger. Wait, Middle Tennessee gets the ball back. They're going for 60. It's always Trippin' Griffin. That's his only second touchdown of the year. What a f***ing disappointment. Middle Tennessee tames the Tigers 62-31. You're in the Home Depot Hall of Fame. Then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler.
The 4th-ranked 7-0 Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in the Carrier Dome playing the 2-5 Syracuse Orange. After two Yates interceptions, Middle Tennessee is on upset alert early, but following a goal line triple option, he cuts the lead in half. The offense gets back on the field quick, and they dial up the rare midfield triple option. He's going to pitch it here, and Black John Smith's got a lot of room. He's got one man to beat. Can he do it? Oh, he hit him with a voodoo spell. He's going to take it the distance. This game's tied up. You blink, and Meatsack is streaking all alone. And he makes the catch. It's too bad it wasn't a scholarship, but it's going to be a touchdown. Up 3 in the 4th, Yates takes an 8-step drop from the shotgun. He's going to throw him a prayer into double coverage. It's Meatsack! He gets the foot down. Throwing it from his own end zone. Who else but Meatsack? Oh, he's going to take it 95 yards for the 50-burger. What's his absent father, Mr. Meatsack, in the end zone waiting for him? He's got something to say. He said still no scholarship. Middle Tennessee deflates Syracuse Dome 55-38. You're going turtle hunting this Saturday. Then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler.
The 8-0 3rd-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are hosting the number 20th Maryland Terrapins. The meat sack is in motion, and the 6'7 wide receiver sneaks into the end zone for the score. Followed up by a surprise piss missile to the All-American sophomore walk-on, Jack Meatsack. 4th and goal, tied up at 14. Yates has a receiver up the seam. It's always Trippin' Griffin, the slowest player on the team, physically and mentally. Still tied up at 21. What's that sound? It's Cheeks getting clapped in the corner. That's a touchdown for William Cheeks III. Middle Tennessee is pulling away. One more touchdown should do it. It's a race to the pylon. It's going to take 4 Terrapins to take down Black John Smith. The dump truck would be proud. 3 seconds left. One more play to try and secure the 50-burger. Everybody and their mom knows what play is coming. Can they stop it? The stadium is dead quiet. Not a peep from any of the kids. The hole is there. No! That was the sound of every clipboard in a 5-mile radius snapping at once. Middle Tennessee stomps the Terrapins 49-35. If you brush your teeth with Mountain Dew, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler.
The 9-0 3rd-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host the 2-7 NC State Wolfpack. Yates said he wanted to go balls deep early, and he launches a piss missile from Steph Curry range. That's never good. Receivers covered up. Oh, what a snag from Trippin' Griffin. Maybe we've been too mean to him. With the safety blitzing, Yates finds the cheek-clapping specialist just chilling behind the defense for the easiest score of the year. Looking to put up 28 in the first half. With nobody open, Yates does what he does best. He forces her, I mean it, to William Cheeks III. Handoff is to Dirk Diggler, who could get benched for Black John Smith. He's going to have to make a couple miss. He's got a lane. He's going to get tackled. No, he breaks it. He's going to have to go over the top. Touchdown, Dirk motherfucking Diggler. Surprise piss missile to end it. Middle Tennessee left the stadium wearing wolfskin. 57-39. If you forgot to invite the kids to this game, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler.
The 10-0 3rd-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are on the road against 9-1 7th-ranked Virginia Tech. The play action gets the safety to bite, which gives William Cheeks III a couple of steps, and Chris Yates is able to hit the man in stride. Middle Tennessee strikes first, and we're already down 7. Goal line triple option for an easy score, and this game's tied up again. down 17 after 3/8 interceptions. We're showing a kickoff. Oh, because Black John Smith has the corner. We get away with a couple blocks to the back. He's got one man to beat. He needs to come back in. Oh, he's going to take it to the house. He's running faster than when Sonny sees a 6'5 quarterback with a rocket arm and no accuracy. Is it comeback time? Yates is going to take a shot deep to meet Sack. Oh, I've seen this movie before. Yep, here comes another one. Dude, that one wasn't even close, man. Drops back again, and I guess that forward pass is going to be a fumble. All right, oh, we're not done yet. Let's go ahead and round up to 5 interceptions. Fuck it. Middle Tennessee gets a first 50-burger at 52. If you're going to take out your rage on poor Boston College, then you must be head coach. Sonny, Prinkler! The 10-1 7th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are hosting... Nah, forget it. It's not going to matter, trust me. Goal line piss missile! Hot and ready piss missile! Piss missile from the upper stratosphere! If cheeks clap in space, do they make a sound? A no-look piss missile! This piss missile doesn't have a scholarship! A Steph Curry range piss missile! The National Weather System has alerted the country of piss missiles traveling at life-threatening speeds! This next one is a limited edition Caucasian piss missile! This particular edition comes exclusively with the ability to underseason your steak! This is the piss missile of the game as Sonny Wrinkle Jr. carries multiple defenders on his back into the end zone with no regard for human life. Last but not least, the final piss missile. I told you, it wasn't gonna matter. Middle Tennessee makes Boston College look like Boston Market. 85-21. If you wish the best for Georgia Tech, then you must be head coach. Sonny Prinkler! It's number 2 Georgia Tech and number 5 Middle Tennessee State for the 2016 ACC Championship game. Yates is looking to go up early, and he finds the All-American former Biletnikoff winner sophomore walk-on Jack Meatsack. Yates is locked onto his target, and he's going to deliver a Heisman-caliber piss missile to William Cheeks III, Middle Tennessee 18, Georgia Tech 7. With this touchdown, we officially have a Sonny Wrinkler shootout. Middle Tennessee up 49-44, looking to try to separate. White-ass Tim Atkins on the corner. He's got a lane. White man can't jump. Touchdown. After taking a 10-step drop, Yates finds the cheek-clapping specialist to secure the 60-burger, and that's going to do it. Middle Tennessee is your 2016 ACC Conference Champions. Sonny Wrinkler has now collected the Conference USA, Pac-12, and now ACC Conference titles. Middle Tennessee State does not leapfrog into the national championship. Instead, it's Sonny v. Oklahoma Part 5 for the Orange Bowl. Let's go make some mimosas. If the Orange Bowl is too healthy for you, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The 3rd-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders take on number 11 Oklahoma for Part 5 of this rivalry. Goal line triple option to get it started, and it's an easy touchdown for Black John Smith. As a senior, this is going to be his last game as a Blue Raider. Don't look now, but Middle Tennessee is down 21. People are saying that Sonny can't win the big one, but this one here is a piss missile to the most fundamentally sound player on the team. Early in the second half, Yates is able to spread cheeks out and find the hole right there in the middle. Comeback time? Getting desperate, Sonny runs only the 2nd screen in his career, and Black John Smith has tons of room. Middle Tennessee has scored 21 points unanswered. Defense gets another stop and allows white-ass Tim Atkins to take the lead. He's not the most athletically gifted, but has tons of grit. Sonny Wrinkler promised to make a Wish Kids a 50-burger. Yates is going deep for the kids. He's got cheeks. Yes, the kids get to live. That's going to do it. Sonny Wrinkler has added the Orange Bowl to his collection. With a 50-35 victory, Middle Tennessee is up 4-1 in this rivalry. Will Sonny leave? If you stayed with Middle Tennessee because they offered you a lifetime supply of clipboards, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The 25th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders visit number 4 Virginia Tech in a trademark Sonny revenge game. In the red zone early, Yates throws the first piss missile of the season to put the Blue Raiders on top. Jack Meatsack has lost the status of impact player to William Cheeks III due to multiple attempts to steal his scholarship. The highlight machine must be broken. Not too sure why we're showing defense. Oh! It's picked off and going the other way! So that's how that feels! Middle Tennessee takes a 21-7 lead over the Virginia Tech Hokies. The first goal line triple option without Black John Smith. The pitch is to his replacement, Jared. No pullout game lane. Oh, he makes the defender look like one of his 37 kids. Touchdown! Knotted up at 35. 9 seconds left in the game. Yates delivers a piss missile to the 2-time All-American former Biletnikoff winner, junior walk-on Jack Meatsack. And that's the ball game. Middle Tennessee shoots up Virginia Tech 42-35. If COVID takes a vaccine for you, then you must be head coach. Sonny Prinkler! The 1-0, 23rd-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host Part 6 of the Sonny v. Oklahoma rivalry. After playing each other 5 times, you'd think they'd be able to stop the goal line triple option, but nope! Middle Tennessee strikes first. Back at the red zone again, Yates fires a piss missile to no pullout game lane for a walk-in touchdown. Only up 4. Dirk Diggler on the ground. He's going to carve up the free safety like Jeffrey Dahmer. He's got one man to beat. He better not get too close. Oh! He hit him with a Dirk Diggler trademark voodoo spell. He's going to take this one 83 yards for the score. Down 3. Yates is scanning the field. He sees Jack. dragging his meat sack along the goal line, is able to fall backwards into the end zone. Middle Tennessee takes the lead. Looking to pull away in the fourth, Yates sneaks a pitch to no pull-out game lane, and he runs faster than when his $9,700 child support bill is due. Touchdown! A defensive highlight in 2 weeks in a row? Huh? Oklahoma trying to go deep! It's Sticky Finger Woods to steal the deal! I do not want to know why they call him that. If you drank 20-plus shots last night, then you must be head coach. Sonny, Prinkler! The 2-0 19th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are now in the SEC. We want Bama. Sonny sticks the fundamentals in the first drive and hits white-ass Tim Atkins for the touchdown. You know what, Jim? He really reminds me a lot of Wes Welker. Only up four. Yates deals a screaming hot piss missile to William Cheeks III. Look at those cheeks! An obvious goal line triple option scenario. The outside is covered. Oh! That was the slowest cut I've ever seen! Touchdown! Follow that up with the red zone triple option. Yates has a ton of green grass ahead of him. He pitches it to the third string running back, David. I still go to Blockbuster Oliver. Fourth and 18. Have to go for it because the punters don't travel with the team. Yates has plenty of time. He's scanning the field. He lets it go. It's caught. It's Tim Atkins. Oh, the sneaky athleticism. White-ass Tim Atkins is going to take it the distance. Kentucky should stick to basketball. Middle Tennessee 42. Kentucky 34. If you got suspended from TikTok Live, then you must be head coach. Sonny, Prinkler. The 3-0 17th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are playing South Carolina, the defending national champions. Dirk Diggler is in motion. He's going to have some blockers, and Dirk Diggler digs his way into the end zone for the score. Yates is going to hit him with the play action, and they take the bait. And that's going to result in an untouched meat sack. We'd like to take this moment to congratulate white-ass Tim Atkins on his full ride scholarship. It's an academic scholarship, of course, but meat sack is still understandably upset. Oh, hey, look, Trippin' Griffin's still on the team. How about that? Following the defense, giving up 17 unanswered points. We have third and long. They drop 8 into coverage. It's Trippin' Griffin again. He lost his dealer this morning, so he's playing for more than just the game. Yates connects with his homie Cheeks to put the 50-burger on the defending national champions. Middle Tennessee 50, South Carolina 31. If you're under investigation for several recruiting violations, then you must be head coach. Sonny, Prinkler. The 14th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in the Buckeye State taking on number 1 Ohio State. Looking to strike first, Sonny dials up the perfect play, and it's white-ass Tim Atkins with the highest GPA on the team. Middle Tennessee forced a turnover, and it's the law that you have to take a shot on the next play, and it's the first streaking meat sack of the season, and it couldn't come at a better time. After another Ohio State turnover, Dirk Diggler on the counter, he's in space. Oh, that guy needed a map, he was so lost. What a move from the Diggler. Surprise piss missile from deep. It's meat sack again. He has to be the best walk-on of all time. Yates has been surprisingly accurate today as he delivers another piss missile to the fan favorite cheek clapping specialist. This play does secure the 50-burger, however, Trippin' Griffin was immediately suspended for 3 games for pulling out an 8-ball for celebration. Middle Tennessee will upset number 1, Ohio State. Rumors are Urban Meyer went to the NFL out of fear of Sonny Wrinkler. Middle Tennessee 56, Ohio State 31. If you're chunkier than a bowl of chunky soup, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The 6th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are hosting number 20, the Mississippi State Bulldogs. If Sonny Wrinkler and the Blue Raiders get off the same start as they did last week against Ohio State, this game will go smoothly. That's it! That's my 13th reason! Middle Tennessee is finally able to get on the board with the Chris Yates goal line triple option. Handoff is to Dirk Diggler. He's got a chance! The DBs are coming! Oh! The Diggler wiggled out of that one! He's gonna take this one all the way to the house! Hopefully the defense can come up with a couple stops! After 3 quarters of football, Middle Tennessee finds himself on an upset alert. Dirk Diggler is single-handedly attempting to put the Blue Raiders team on his back. He just got shot out of a cannon! Look at those wheels! Nobody's gonna catch him, especially that guy taking a terrible angle! Middle Tennessee is going to take the lead for the first time in this ballgame. Middle Tennessee avoids a tragic upset 55-45. If SportsCenter has named you the Burger King, then you must be head coach. Sonny Prinkler! The 4th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host the struggling unranked Auburn Tigers. On defense first, it's a quick pass to the left, and it's picked off by Washington! Sonny doesn't learn the first name of his defensive players. Ring, ring, hello. Yeah! Did someone order a house call? Because this one's going to be a touchdown! Finally in the red zone, Yates drops back and delivers a piss missile to Trippin' Griffin. Isn't he suspended? Midfield goal line triple option. Yates gets rid of it. Lane's in trouble. Oh, what a juke! No pull-out game lane is running faster than when his 37 baby mamas are chasing him. Run that play back. Yates has a ton of space. Great pitch! The guy who never pulls out might have another one. The safety has an angle. Oh, he got hit with a Derrick Henry stiff arm. What a run! Meat sack was taken out of the game with this concussion. Dirk Diggler puts the cherry on top with his dig touchdown. Middle Tennessee runs a train through Auburn, 42-28. If you thought Death Valley was a stroll through the park, then you must be head coach. Sonny Prinkler! The 4th-ranked undefeated Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are facing off against the LSU Tigers. Look at that fundamental route by white-ass Tim Atkins, just a student of the game. down three in what could be a trap game. Yates decides to launch it into double coverage per usual, and it's a dime to William Cheeks III. What a throw! LSU is driving down the field. He looks towards the sideline. It's going the other way, thanks to Sticky Finger Woods. Trust me, guys, you really don't want to know why they call him that. Back-to-back games with a defensive touchdown. Trying to go up 18 at the half. Yates launches it deep again, and it's a dime again! They must not let kids in this game. Nobody studies film more than white-ass Tim Atkins, and that's why he is more wide open than Chris Yates' mouth at a daycare. Dirk Diggler on the inside handoff. He's able to weave in and out of traffic, and he finds the hole, and he's off! But the corner's gonna chase him down like DK Metcalf! No, he's gonna drag his bitch ass into the end zone! Sonny leaves with Mike the Tiger's head. If you sleep with a playbook under your pillow, then you must be head coach. Sonny, Sprinkler! The fourth-ranked undefeated Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders take on number 12, the Ole Miss Rebels. Chris Yates starts the game 3-3, including this piff missile to white-ass Tim Atkins. In the red zone again, Yates is searching. He sees a kid in the stands. He's bolting! Chris Yates with the sneaky athleticism! 2-minute drill to end the half results in a touchdown for the two-time All-American former Biletnikoff Award winner junior walk-on Jack Meatsack. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a Sonny Wrinkler shootout! With Yates out, the handoff is to no pull-out game Lane, who does what he does best, finds the hole, and never leaves till he's finished. After a shot of morphine, Yates is back in, and he's rolling out. He finds Sonny's long-lost black son for the 50-burger! Yes, sir! This is going to be back-to-back-to-back games with defensive touchdowns! This is our year! With 1 second left, Sonny wants the 70-burger. There's only one play in this situation. The goal line triple option! 70-burger! Middle Tennessee runs through the Rebels like the Union Army. 72-24.
If you're trying to figure out why a dog is Texas A&M's mascot, then you must be head coach.
Sonny! Winkler!
The third-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are at Kyle Field playing number 11, Texas A&M. In the red zone early, Yates finds the third-string running back David. I still go to Blockbuster Oliver for the score. Nobody has a wider route tree than white-ass Tim Atkins. Hardest worker on the team, he's just overcome so much without having those natural athletic abilities. With another white-ass Tim Atkins score, can he become the first white Biletnikoff Award winner since 2005? Goal line triple option produces a hole for Big Daddy Dirk Diggler. Late in the fourth, Yates rears back and throws a freaky fast piff missile to William Cheeks. Look at those wheels! I've never wanted Cheeks involved in my burgers until right now. Hit him with the play action. It's gonna be a broken coverage! Nobody is within 5 miles of the cheek clapping specialist! Put the 60-burger on the grill! Middle Tennessee takes home Reveille the Dog, 68-58. Won 27 home games in a row, then you must be head coach.
Sonny, Winkler!
The second-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders hosting the Nick Saban-led Alabama Crimson Tide. Chris Yates starts off the game with a red zone piff missile to the man with 37 kids under the age of 2. Tied up at 7, Yates' offensive line offers him up on a silver platter, and Alabama is going to scoop it up and then trip over his lifeless body. No pull-out game Lane is able to fill the hole, and he's going to impregnate the end zone to put Middle Tennessee on top. Dirk Diggler couldn't get it up on the ground, so he stiffens up the defense with a slant to put the Blue Raiders up 8 points. Now they're down 8, looking to score. When he's not at Blockbuster, he's catching piss missiles in the mouth from Chris Yates. Down 10, 2 minutes to go. Jack streaks his meat sack, and Yates delivers a bomb, and he's able to pull himself into the end zone to try and avoid the home upset. Middle Tennessee will lose to Nick Saban and the Alabama Crimson Tide, 39-36. If you're not sorry about what is about to happen to Vanderbilt, then you must be head coach.
Sonny, Winkler!
The sixth-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host the measly Vanderbilt Commodores. Big Daddy Dirk may not win the Heisman, but he will win our hearts. Vanderbilt must have watched zero film as Dirk Diggler takes it to the outside, makes one cut, and he's going to race to the pylon for his second touchdown of the game. And back-to-back games, we're going to have a streaking meat sack. Chris Yates throws him open with a beautiful bomb, and that's going to be an easy meat sack touchdown. Yates is running like the FBI is chasing him again, and he's going to have Sonny's long-lost black son in the corner of the end zone for a touchdown. This game has seen piss missile after piss missile after piss missile. Yates is absolutely locked in tonight on Youth Night. Looking to secure the 70-burger, Sonny's son catches his second touchdown of the game, which is good because he usually disappoints his father. Middle Tennessee rolls through the Commodores 77-48. If you're looking to add the SEC to your collection, then you must be head coach.
Sonny, Winkler!
It's the battle of the state of Tennessee and the Southeastern Conference. Okay, so I know this doesn't look good, but Sonny was in the locker room dealing with a Chris Yates situation will be fine. A perfectly executed goal line triple option resorts in a Big Daddy Dirk touchdown. Red zone slants. He usually finds white-ass Tim Atkins here. He's covered. It's a piss missile to the cheek-clapping specialist. 3 seconds left in the half. Tied up at 8-28. No pull-out game Lane elevates to snag the piss missile from the senior quarterback, Chris Yates. The crowd is chanting meat sack, and you get what you wished for. This is an untouched meat sack.
He's the front runner for the Blitnikoff Award, the most fundamental player in the country. It's white ass Tim Mackens, baby, we love you. Time is running out. Yates throws a 70 burger edition piss missile to secure it, and that's gonna do it. Middle Tennessee will be your SEC champions. Sonny Wrinkler has now collected 3 out of 5 Infinity Stones. I meant Power 5 conference titles. Middle Tennessee is headed to the Sugar Bowl. If you brought insulin to the Sugar Bowl, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler. The 4th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are playing the 22nd-ranked UCF Golden Knights in what they've claimed is the national championship game. This game got off to a hotter start to the Big Ten commissioner's wife, as No Pullout Game Lane scores from deep. No Pullout Game Lane's 39th child was born earlier today, but of course, he missed it. After the first quarter, it's clear we have a Sonny Wrinkler shootout! Surprise piss missile to the 2-time All-American former Blitnikoff Award winner junior walk-on Jack Meatsack. Headed into the fourth quarter, Middle Tennessee leads 49-45. Hope you bet the over. Needing to score to stay on top, it's the senior, I Still Go to Blockbuster Oliver, in his final game as a Blue Raider. Down 3, 15 seconds left. Same play again. It's Blockbuster again! They're gonna win this game! Middle Tennessee wins 70-66. Sonny Wrinkler got so drunk after the game that he declined every coaching offer and will return for one more year.
He's improvable, he ain't no Eagle Scout, and he's got everything except a pair of eyes. Chris throws another pick. I laugh 'cause it's so damn funny. He can't even see any of the linebackers. We are in so love. Chris Yates, you got it right. I wonder if he knows he's all we think about tonight. He's the reason for the teardrops on my playbook. The only thing that's keeping me out of the fucking bar. They were wrong, he's a star. Keep on singing those peace missiles.
If you're starting the revenge tour in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! Nick Saban, Sonny Wrinkler, part 2. Enough said. Down 7 early, the returning star running back Big Daddy Dirk Diggler proves why he should be a Heisman candidate, and he ghosted Alabama like Lane Kiffin. Making his debut at quarterback, it's Jeremy Beat My Meat Overstreet. 4th and goal. Overstreet has to escape the pocket. He's gonna run it! Wait! No! He's gonna set his feet and zip it in there! Whoa, that one had some heat on it. In the red zone again. A receiver has some room over the middle. Great throw! Could Beat My Meat be better than Chris Yates? Nah, just kidding. He threw 4 picks today. However speaking, Chris Yates could have never made this play. Whoa, that's a Vince Young impression right there. Sonny evens it up against Nick Saban, 42-37. You're banging the Big Ten commissioner's wife now. Then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! Ladies and gentlemen, it's the historic rivalry, Sonny v. Oklahoma Part 7. Let's get it. Oklahoma's gonna have nightmares about Big Daddy Dirk Diggler as he puts their entire defense in a blender to take the lead. Is Diggler Heisman material? Beat My Meat Overstreet brings an entire different element to the goal line triple option, and I expect to see it all season long. Jim, this defense wouldn't be able to stop Helen Keller. Scratch that! This one's coming back to the hoose! Defense wins championships! 3rd and 13, Overstreet's gonna have to throw it downfield, which is the most terrifying thing ever. It's the fan favorite, Glass Bones Jones, who avoids injury once again. Guess who? It's the monster of Oklahoma, Big Daddy Dirk Diggler. Trying to secure the 50 burger, the Slants produce an easy touchdown, but they fail the 2-point conversion. No burger! With the 50 burger slipping away, the defense causes a safety! That's gonna be a 50 burger! Sonny takes a 6-1 lead in the series, 50-38. You can't decide if this is a tune-up or a trap game, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The undefeated 5th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host the Fighting Illini? Or still Division 1? Overstreet is just way too athletic for this mid-major caliber team. Fun fact, Jim, he got his nickname for his pre-game ritual. Beat My Meat drops back and connects with his homie from another race, white-ass Tim Mackens. He's escaping quicker than El Chapo and running faster than when he sees a fresh pot of lotion! What a run for the junior quarterback! Could he be good? Off to the races again. Does he even look to throw? This is his 4th touchdown of the first half. Surprise lotion bomb to the cheek clapping specialist. I expect those two to be very close. The defense went back to their default state of giving up 40 plus points a game, but it doesn't matter because they got 60 burgered. Sonny knocked out the Fighting Illini, 60-42. If you're not gonna make a Gamecock joke because it's too easy, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The 4th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in Columbia, taking on the number 6 South Carolina Gamecocks under the bright lights. Jeremy, who are you throwing that to? Are you seeing ghosts? Okay, need a score here to even up. Nobody's open. Run with it! Or just throw it right to the safety. That's fine, too. The backup quarterback, Hold My Balls McCall, is warming up on the sideline. Couldn't we see a quarterback change? Down 17. Beat My Meat needs to make something happen here or he will get benched. White ass Tim Atkins saved the day, converting on 4th down and bringing Middle Tennessee within 10. In the red zone again. Don't you dare throw this ball over street. He's taking off quicker than No Pullout Game Lane when she says she's pregnant. That's an over street touchdown. Down 10. Headed into the 4th. Can they complete the comeback? Half the score. The game's over. It's a massive lotion bomb to Michael Jordan Harris. It's all up to the defense now. 11 seconds left. Down 3. One play call to win it all. Overstreet's gonna have to keep it. He pitches it. Fumble! Overstreet picks it back up. Middle Tennessee is going to win. Sonny Wrinkler strokes the Gamecocks. 35-31. Damn it, I said I wasn't gonna do that. You're coaching from Nick Saban's office. Then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The undefeated second-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are taking on Nebraska in a top 5 matchup. Beat My Meat, Overstreet ran out of lotion before the game and is going to take his frustrations out on the Cornhuskers. Nebraska tried to DDoS the Blue Raiders' offense, making them slower than usual. But Big Daddy Dirk Diggler was still able to find the end zone despite running in molasses. Escaping justice like Jeffrey Epstein, Overstreet was able to escape the pocket and have enough of lotion for this lotion bomb to Glassbones Jones, who still hasn't gotten hurt. With Middle Tennessee up 28-10 going into the half, the burgers have been put on the grill. Looks like Coach dialed up this one for his long-lost black son, and you can just see Coach's excitement when his son makes a play. 30 for 30 is doing a 6-hour-long documentary on the goal line triple option and its origin and what makes it successful. Surprise lotion bomb to white-ass Tim Atkins, who stays up long enough to secure the 50-burger. 4th and 26. Sonny trying to get the ball back for the 60-burger. They hit the quarterback, who throws a dime mid-backflip to convert on 4th down. Coach is obviously upset. And there goes the clipboard! Oh, it goes all the way across the field. Even with the blatant witchcraftery, Meat Sack was still able to secure the 60-burger. Sonny shucked the Cornhuskers, 64-31. Motioning over like that. What the fuck was that? Huh? What the fuck? What? It fucking skews me? What the fuck was that? If you put so much butter in your popcorn that it's basically soup, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The undefeated first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host Jim Harbaugh and the Wolverines. The Heisman frontrunner Beat My Meat Overstreet proves that speed kills as he beats the defense to the pylon. Following an Overstreet turnover, the defense is able to come up with 2 points of their own for their second safety of the year. Beat My Meat Overstreet runs as free as O.J. Simpson as he walks right into the end zone. Overstreet rolls out and hits white-ass Tim Atkins with a lotion bomb as the defense collapses. He cuts harder than an emo girl who says rawr and puts Middle Tennessee up 17. Only up 3 in the 4th. White-ass Tim Atkins scores his 3rd touchdown of the game. What a feature for the least athletic player on the team. 1 minute left of the game. Needing to score. No pullout game lane hits him with an absolute voodoo spell. And with ice in his veins, he calls game. Sonny sends Jim Harbaugh back to the NFL. 58-42. If you think Tom Izzo was in on it, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The undefeated first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host the Michigan State Spartans. Midfield triple option. Overstreet has some space, but delivers a perfect pitch to No Pullout Game Lane, who could go all the way. He's got one man to beat. He's going to score a touchdown! Surprise lotion bomb to the cheek-clapping specialist. Those two have become alarmingly close. Big Daddy Dirk Diggler didn't have much to work with here, but he's able to find the hole and then body surf his way into the end zone to put the Blue Raiders up 7. Fan favorite freshman, Glassbones Jones, avoids an injury and snags a touchdown. With the 50-burger out of sight, David Johnson comes flying through the defense for the safety. The 50-burger is back on the grill. The only Middle Tennessee player with higher than a 3.0 GPA is able to secure the 50-burger! Middle Tennessee runs through the Spartans like the Persians, 50-24. If you thought the Notre Dame burned down, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! It's number 1 versus number 2 in South Bend, Indiana, in what could be a preview of the national championship game. Beat My Meat sneaks a load in to score the first touchdown of the game. With Sonny expecting the quarterback, which Craftery, Chance Townsend is able to overcome his mom's decision and name him Chance, and he's going to take this pick all the way back to the house. In fall in the game, he decided to change his name to Frederick Burns. A rolling out Overstreet is able to set his feet and deliver a lotion bomb to the Foley Scholarship Jack Meatsack. William Cheeks III puts Middle Tennessee up 28-0. Nobody except Sonny Wrinkler saw this coming.
With time expiring in the first half, Overstreet finds an untouched meat sack who is able to dice up the defense like Guy Fieri. We're going to head into overtime up 35-0. This is getting ugly. That little leprechaun better watch out as the cheek-clapping specialist locks eyes with him after tearing through the defense. Overstreet spotted a fresh bottle of lotion, and he's going to take off towards it with reckless abandon, securing the 60-burger along the way. Sonny is going to take down the church, 64-21. Your 6.5-point favorites at Ohio State, then you must be a head coach. Sonny, Winkler! The undefeated first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are in Columbus, Ohio, taking on the Buckeyes. Goal line triple option to start. It frees up no pull-out game land as he scores on a big day for him. It's 9 of his kids' birthdays. Beat My Meat is 5-6 so far and is driving again. He's taking off, breaks a tackle. He makes a couple defenders miss and almost scores. With him out there, they don't stand a chance. And he's hurt. Backup quarterback holding My Balls McCall with a nice pitch and catch to white-ass Tim Mackins to put Middle Tennessee up 21-3. With Beat My Meat out with a concussion, Big Daddy Dirk Diggler is putting the offense on his back with the sweet footwork and the 2020 vision. Hold My Balls McCall and his 57 speed run the triple option to perfection. However, this will be the last time Middle Tennessee scores as the backup quarterback struggles in the fourth quarter. Sonny cracks open the Buckeyes, 48-41. If you think their marching band is better than their football team, then you must be head coach. Sonny, Prickler! The undefeated first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are taking on the Purdue Boilermakers. Middle Tennessee down 10 in the first half, showing signs of a trap game. Big Daddy Dirk Diggler is able to bring the Blue Raiders within three. Back from his concussion, looking to steal the lead and momentum. Beat My Meat Overstreet rolls out and slings a lotion bomb to a wide open Sonny Wrinkler Jr. Sonny is back on top how he likes it. Overstreet takes a snap and immediately runs for his life. Sets his feet, throws it between three defenders, and white-ass Tim Mackins is off to the races. Run, Forrest, run! This is the fastest I've ever seen this white fella run. A slippery lotion bomb to white-ass Tim Mackins for another deep score. Can Overstreet throw? Huh? Whoa! Heads up! It's raining down lotion bombs on the Boilermakers! Ugh, it's sticky! Please, Lord, not another one! This one's to a streaking meat sack who breaks a tackle and drags his sack into the end zone. Surprise lotion bomb to white-ass Tim Atkins for the 60-burger! Ew, that one had chunks in it! Sonny derails the Boilermakers, 64-42. If you're a quarterback, learn how to throw, then you must be head coach. Sonny, Winkler! The undefeated first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host the 4-win Northwestern Wildcats. The lotioned-up Beat My Meat Overstreet rolls out, sets his feet, and zips one into Michael Jordan Harris, and this offense is off to the races. Overstreet drops back, looking to put the lotion in the basket again. He lobs a lotion bomb that's caught by the toe-tapping cheeks. With nobody open, Beat My Meat said, fine, I'll do it myself. Weaving in and out of traffic like Paul Walker. I forgot that one didn't end well. Northwestern throws up a pair to end the half, and Sticky Finger Woods said, no praying in my house. Then he takes off quicker than Judas after the plot twist of the generation. With this pick six, Middle Tennessee will put up 42 points in the first half. And ladies and gentlemen, it's a Sonny Wrinkler shootout. You know they say defense wins championships, and we have the best defensive player in the nation, David Motherfucking Johnson. He leads the nation in sacks, tackles, and with this pick six, it's also going to secure the 70-burger. Sonny Wrinkler has already left the stadium to start setting up the tables at the local Chuck E. Cheese. Sonny puts the Wildcats on the endangered species list, 76-28. If you're trying to figure out what owls have to do with rice, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The undefeated first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders take on Rice at Sports Authority Field at Mile High for the last game of the regular season. After a scoreless first quarter, Beat My Meat takes off faster than Sonny when the buffet closes and is able to beat off the defense. Wait, what? Digging deep in the playbook for a screen pass, no pull-out game lane shows that he has the ability to finish on and off the field. Beat My Meat is heating up, and with this lotion bomb to William Cheeks III, who wipes his cheeks across the defense. The cheek-clapping specialist has spread out the defense and ruthlessly just clapped away. Looks like Overstreet is setting them deep. Bad idea. It's a sticky lotion bomb to Wrinkler Jr. for the score. With time running out, they need to get the 50-burger or Sonny will make them run. It's all up to the goal line triple option on the two-point conversion. It has been secured by the Heisman frontrunner. Sonny has completed the undefeated regular season, 50-30. The official Wikipedia page for Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders football, and it says head coach, Sonny Wrinkler! If you can't believe that Illinois made it to the conference championship, then you must be head coach, Sonny Wrinkler! It's Middle Tennessee versus Illinois for the Big Ten title!
First drive of the game resulted in a Big Daddy Dirk Diggler touchdown, who ran a train on the Fighting Illini previously in this season. Even when they say no, no pull-out game Lane still doesn't pull out. Now that is dedication to the game. After Sonny blatantly ripped off the halftime speech from Friday Night Lights, Overstreet and Dirk Diggler on fire, chanting, clear eyes, full hearts, can't lose. Clear eyes, full hearts, can't lose. 3 seconds left, one play for the 70 burger. Cheeks is going deep, can't Overstreet get it there? Cheeks has a step, the lotion bomb is airborne. The 70 burger is secured. The Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are your Big Ten champions. Sonny Wrinkler has now collected 4 out of 5 Infinity Stones with just the Big 12 remaining. But most importantly, your Blue Raiders are headed to the national championship to face off against Georgia Tech. You showed up to the game 36 hours early, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! It's the BCS National Championship featuring your Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders facing off against the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets. Overstreet's gonna keep it. Oh, his head got ripped off, but still manages to cross the goal line. That's grit. He drops back. He's gonna tuck it like James Charles and take off. He's gonna get there. Looks like Georgia Tech is gonna have a hard time stopping him from beating his meat. Nobody runs a better slant than an unathletic white guy, and we have the best, white-ass Tim Atkins. Following an interception, Meat Sack is streaking, and the lotion bomb is headed towards the back of the end zone. Touchdown! 4th and 8. Needing to convert, Overstreet is scanning the field. They forgot about the white guy who's streaking up the sideline. That touchdown was easier than Urban Meyer's wife. Overstreet escapes the pocket, looking to run. Wait a second, he sets his feet and zips a fiery lotion bomb to guess who, the white guy. With the 50 burger secured, all you can hear from the crowd is beat that meat, beat that meat. In honor of the Heisman quarterback, beat my meat, Overstreet. That touchdown is gonna do it. 56-38, your final score. Sonny Wrinkler and your Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are your national champions. With Sonny's contract expiring, only one question remains. Where will Sonny go? Chuck Norris checks under his bed for you. Then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! It's coaching carousel time, and we will be leaving it up to the fans. Here are your options. The Florida Gators. The Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders. The Vanderbilt Commodores, and the UCLA Bruins. I will comment each team down below, and you will cast your vote by liking that particular comment. Let the games begin. If you have type 1 and type 2 diabetes, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! I'll be returning to Middle Tennessee State to complete my Infinity Gauntlet, and therefore transferring to the Big 12. Season will start tonight, 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Twitch link is in the bio. If you scheduled the Wisconsin Badgers just for the cheese, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The 6th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are taking on the 15th-ranked Wisconsin Badgers. Beat My Meat is invading Camp Randall as he rolls out, sets his feet, and delivers a strike to the cheek-clapping specialist for the first score of the game. Overstreet drops back and immediately takes off like his father before he can even beat his little meat. Looks like Wisconsin fans are used to this as they already look for the exits. Looking to de-cleat the Badgers, Overstreet fires a lotion bomb to the whitest guy in Wisconsin, white-ass Tim Atkins, who carries a couple defenders into the end zone. What a blue-collar guy. Looking for the 50-burger, Michael Jordan Harris runs a great route and shows why he is better than LeBron. The route is on as even Glass Bones Jones gets into the fun by going over top and is still avoiding all major injuries. A chance for the 70-burger. Beat My Meat Overstreet throws into coverage, but it's white-ass Tim Atkins with the one-handed snag. Are we sure he's still white? Sonny has 70-burgered the Badgers, 71-52. If you're about to give Army Vietnam flashbacks, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The 6th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders take on Army in the Alamo Dome. Remember the Alamo. Overstreet gets his meat going with a lotion bomb to the wide-open, white-ass Tim Atkins. Beat My Meat Overstreet rolls out and finds Big Daddy Dirk Diggler over the middle, who gets held up in the air like Rose from Titanic. Army is lining up for a 58-yard field goal. Let's take a live look in.
Not have the leg. And Chris Davis takes it in the back of the end zone. He'll run it out to the 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 45. There goes Davis.
Oh, my God.
Davis is going to run it all the way back. Auburn's going to win the football game. Auburn's going to.
Surprise lotion bomb to Michael Jordan Harris for the 50-burger. Looking for 70. Overstreet throws it up to the man who is double-cheeked every Saturday, the cheek-clapping specialist. 11 seconds left. One more chance for a 90-point performance. Overstreet channels a piss missile, and Cheeks is going to cap off the 90 burger. Sonny caused the whole football team to go AWOL. 94-34. If you own the state of Tennessee, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Prinkler.
The Third Ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders take on number 8 Tennessee in a top 10 matchup. Beat My Meat Overstreet has already finished twice this game, looking for his third. He finds the big fella who finds the end zone. Looking to put up 28 in the first quarter. It's a lotion bomb to the big fella again. Is he good now? Huh? Overstreet secures the 50 burger in the first half? Did Tennessee ask for literal volunteers to play in this game? 2 seconds left in the half. Looking to run up the score per usual. Overstreet throws a juicy lotion bomb. I really hope running up the score doesn't bite us in the ass. Beat My Meat Overstreet is down. I repeat, Beat My Meat Overstreet is down. Jeremy, Beat My Meat Overstreet has torn his pectoral muscle and will be out for 3 weeks. Maybe we should have taken him out up 40. The freshman lefty gunslinger hits Mr. Fundamental for the 80 burger, and this offense didn't skip a beat. Looking for the world's first 100 burger, the lefty finds Glassbones Jones, who was more open than Monica Lewinsky's mouth. Middle Tennessee and Sonny Wrinkler obliterate the Volunteers, 108-52. If your blood is 95% Diet Coke, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
The first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are taking on the Horned Frogs. Did Sesame Street pick your mascot? After 2 rushing touchdowns, the lefty gunslinger gets his first touchdown as a starter in place of the injured Beat My Meat. With time expiring in the first half, the lefty's gonna set his feet and let one fly! And it's the cheek clapping specialist! He's all alone! He's gonna skip into the end zone like it's the fucking Wizard of Oz! Surprise Red Rocket to Glassbones Jones! Could there be a quarterback controversy? Forget about the quarterbacks. It's Big Daddy Dirk Diggler, who's running faster than Tom Cruise in any of his movies. That dude is always running. Just watch any Mission Impossible. Middle Tennessee is up 16, headed into the fourth quarter. Sonny is already in the stands looking for their coach's wife. Looking for the 50 burger. Glassbones Jones is able to get free with an amazing block by white-ass Tim Atkins. He just does the little things right. Hardest worker on the team. Trying to run up the score. The lefty gunslinger cashes in another one and racks up over 700 passing yards in this game. Did Overstreet lose his job? What did you guys expect? They're literally just a frog with horns. 76-40. If you thought you scheduled Longhorn Steakhouse, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
Your first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are hosting the sixth-ranked Texas Longhorns. Not even 30 seconds into the game, the lefty gunslinger finds Glassbones Jones, who has remained healthy for 2 seasons despite an injury rating of 1. Down 7 and needing a spark, William Cheeks III returns the kick. He makes a move to the left like Beyonce and takes off down the sidelines. It's like someone's chasing him about his car's extended warranty. He could go all the way. Touchdown. Down 10, Big Daddy Dirk Diggler is able to keep the crowd engaged with the goal line pitch. Middle Tennessee is officially on upset alert, down 10, headed into the fourth quarter. The defensive coordinator has already gone missing. Little do they know, Sonny Wrinkler loves being behind. It's his favorite position as the Blue Raiders dominated the entirety of the fourth quarter, with William Cheeks and Big Daddy Dirk Diggler tag-teaming the Longhorn defense. On fourth down, it's Texas's last hope. The defense is finally able to make a stop. It's too bad the defensive coordinator was not alive to see it. In an attempt to run the clock out, Big Daddy Dirk Diggler said, "Fuck that! I'm going for a 60 burger," as he races to the end zone completely untouched. Sonny Wrinkler and the Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders will avoid the upset and remain undefeated. 63-58. If you fall asleep with a clipboard in your hand, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
After playing TCU and the Texas Longhorns, the first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders will play their third Texas school in a row, Texas Tech. Behind early, Beat My Meat Overstreet is able to hit Michael Jordan Harris with a lotion bomb to tie up this ballgame. Following multiple Overstreet turnovers, Middle Tennessee is down 21 points. It seems the only thing they can rely on is a white-ass Tim Atkins slant. Nobody saw this coming as the top team in the country is down 14 points headed into the second half. With Overstreet sucking his own balls, we pitch it to the third-string running back, but the Blue Raiders are still down 14. The comeback looks improbable as William Cheeks III has broken his ribs and is out for 3 weeks. Since Beat My Meat Overstreet couldn't hit water if he fell out of a boat, we used him for all he's good for, his legs. Wait a second, this is a one-score game. Oh dear God, he's throwing it. Don't throw a pick, don't throw a pick, don't throw a pick. Glassbones Jones with the catch. This game is all tied up at 49-49, headed into the fourth quarter. This is a certified Sonny Wrinkler shootout. After holding Texas Tech to a field goal, which is basically a stop, they brought in the 5'4 speedy freshman to get around the corner, and Middle Tennessee has taken their first lead of the game. This defense just needs to get one fucking stop. We are doomed.
Wait a second. Jade Edwards with the interception. He's got ice in his veins. He just called game. Sonny proves the Blue Raiders are better than Red Raiders. 64-52. If you hold all the high scores at David Buster's, then you must be head coach. Sonny Winkler. Your first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are hosting the Oklahoma State Cowboys. Trying to even the score, Beat My Meat Overstreet is able to hit the tight end, who is so fat, it looks like he ate the previous tight end. He might be fat, but he's got two touchdowns in this game already. Maybe we should let him sleep inside now. Quick throw to the left, but Chance said, give me that shit! And he's going to take it back 81 yards for the score. That is an NCAA record. However, he did rupture a disc diving into the end zone, so Chance Townsend is out for the rest of the season. Overstreet is looking deep, and he's going to find his favorite streaking white boy, Mr. Fundamental himself, who's able to get both the feet in for the score. After 9 turnovers, Beat My Meat Overstreet was benched for the lefty gunslinger. It's Willie Wallace! Who the fuck is that? Who cares? Touchdown! With 2 minutes left, the score here would end it. Dirk Diggler drops the mic of the Cowboys. This game is over! Despite Beat My Meat's best efforts to throw this game, Middle Tennessee escapes 64-62. You thought 9-11 was a gas station? Then you must be head coach. Sonny Winkler! The first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are visiting the Baylor Bears. Overstreet is able to move like Jagger as he gets out of the pocket to find the fifth-string wide receiver Dustin Givens for the score. Dirk Diggler proves why he is a big daddy as he rolls over the defense like bowling pins. Beat My Meat Overstreet looks downfield for a second, but then takes off quicker than O.J. Simpson in a Ford Bronco, and this touchdown will give Middle Tennessee the lead. Overstreet drops back and delivers an absolute lotion bomb to white-ass Tim Atkins, who is wearing socks with sandals. That's just white-ass. Taking a shot downfield. Can Overstreet's noodle arm get it there? The ball is up! He can! And it's his new favorite white boy, Glassbones Jones! 50-burger! Dirk Diggler on the pitch to solidify the win, and Middle Tennessee is able to rip apart the Bernstein Bears, 64-49.
How far would you drive for the girl of your dreams?
I would drive anywhere.
What about to Nebraska?
Oh,
go to Nebraska?
Fuck no, Nick.
If you're too fat to ride the ride at Six Flags, then you must be head coach. Sonny Winkler! The undefeated first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders take on the winless Kansas State Wildcats. Overstreet takes a snap and immediately takes off with no intention of ever throwing that football. He's just as talented as NFL running back Lamar Jackson. World-famous goal-line triple option results in a touchdown for Big Daddy Dirk Diggler, who just recently appeared on the cover of a Playboy magazine. Kansas State coach is going to have nightmares about the goal-line triple option tonight as their defense continues to get bent over the kitchen table. Beat My Meat Overstreet drops back, peels back the other direction. I'm 99% sure that he is just afraid to throw the football, but touchdown! Oh, fuck! He's looking to throw!
Oh, hey, that's not too bad, no.
Beat My Meat Overstreet is heating up as he hits Sonny Winkler Jr., and I haven't seen a fat man run this fast since the big donut shortage of 2008. With the 50-burger already secured, Overstreet's looking to disrespect, and he finds the fifth-string wide receiver, Dustin. I didn't fuck those chickens, Givens.
Wait, that can't be his name.
One more goal-line triple option to really burn it into their fucking skulls. You don't like it? Stop it! Middle Tennessee coasts on the back of Dirk Diggler's 4 touchdowns, 80-51. If you only eat the yellow snow, then you must be head coach. Sonny! Winkler! Undefeated first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders taking on Kansas in the first snow game of the year. Beat My Meat Overstreet is rolling out, looking to run again. Wait, he sets his feet and delivers a lotion bomb! 50 yards downfield to the big fella who is going to need oxygen ASAP. Overstreet is able to walk into the end zone with the unstoppable goal line triple option. Winner is here, bitch! And Big Daddy Dirk Diggler with another touchdown! This game is getting out of hand. Overstreet is looking downfield and hits white-ass Tim Atkins, who is so white the defense can barely see him in the snow. One chance for the 50-burger. Beat My Meat Overstreet's looking downfield, has receivers open. Who the fuck was that to? That's it. Former Heisman Award winner Jeremy Beat My Meat Overstreet is officially benched. Expect to see the lefty against Old Dominion next week. Middle Tennessee stabs Kansas in the back like it was the Red Wedding, 48-30. If you could turn water into a burger, then you must be head coach. Sonny Winkler! The undefeated first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders take on the Old Dominion Monarchs. With the lefty gunslinger getting the start, he quickly shows why he is a better option than Overstreet. Touchdown, Michael Jordan Harris. Goal line triple option from Middle Tennessee's 42-yard line. The very slow lefty keeps it, and he pitches it to the little fella. The 5'5" springy freshman looking like an Oompa Loompa has plenty of space. Can he get there? He has to shit a tackler, and he's there! Touchdown! What a run!
The lefty hands it off to Dirk Diggler, and it's going to be a 1v1 with the safety. Who's going to get there? Oh, it's Big Daddy Dirk Diggler with the hurdle! He jumped so high, he could have cleared the border. Only a 4. Cheeks takes the return, and he's going to make his cut to the left. He's got a lane. One defender has an angle. What's he going to do? He's going to break his ankles at the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10, 101 yards for a touchdown. Struggling to get the 50 burger. The lefty is looking deep. He sees his favorite streaking white boy, and he's going to make the catch while holding on to his doctorate degree. That's just white ass. Sonny Wrinkler brought a butterfly net to deal with the Monarchs. 70-52. If you don't even consider this a rivalry, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! Ladies and gentlemen, it's Rivalry Week, Sonny v. Oklahoma, Part 8, on the Smurf Turf. Third and goal. The lefty checks it down to the Oompa Loompa, who puts the DB in a blender to put Middle Tennessee on the board. Gunslinger drops back, looking to tie up the game, and finds the big fella who makes the catch with a chicken wing in his mouth. Very impressive. Oklahoma on their own 7. Sonny's bringing the hoose. Quarterback tries to reverse out, but Rhodes closed, bitch! Safety! 2 seconds left in the half. Trying to take the lead. The big fella's open. Sonny Wrinkler Jr. kind of looking athletic? Huh? The gunslinger drops back. Hits this one into... Wait, what? How is... Overstreet? How the fuck did he get out there? Fourth quarter action. Starts off with a reverse low shit bomb as Overstreet will be on the other side of this 84-yard bomb as he's able to use his speed. Can he win Heisman as a wide receiver? What a story that would be. Big Daddy Dirk Diggler with the Mortal Kombat finishing move. Sonny takes a 7-1 lead in the rivalry, 67-57. Middle Tennessee will take on number 5 Texas in the Big 12 title game. If you're about to collect your 5th Infinity Stone, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The first-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders take on number 5 Texas for the Big 12 title. Big Daddy Dirk Diggler put their star safety in a freaking blunder for the first score of the game. Middle Tennessee takes the lead. The lefty gunslinger finds the most injury-prone healthy guy of all time, Glass Bones Jones. How does he not get hurt? The cheek-clapping specialist takes a page from white-ass Tim Atkins' book with a fundamental slant route. Beat My Meat Overstreet has entered the game via popular demand as the crowd chants, Beat That Meat! Following a disastrous third quarter, Middle Tennessee is down 21 points headed into the fourth quarter. Beat My Meat Overstreet, trying to engineer the biggest comeback in NCAA history, rolls out and hits Mr. Fundamental for the touchdown. We're going to need a lot more than that. Plenty of time left. Overstreet's able to summon up a lotion bomb to the cheek clapping specialist. And just like that, this is a one-score game with 4 minutes left. One score needed to tie. No! We forgot that Overstreet can't read a zone. Middle Tennessee's comeback falls just short. Sonny Wrinkler does not achieve the Infinity Gauntlet this year. Final score, 56-49. If you think the Fiesta Bowl is candy ass, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! The number 4 ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders face off against number 5 Nebraska in what feels like a consolation game. Beat My Meat Overstreet getting the start in his final collegiate game. It's William Cheeks III with a lotion bomb! I haven't seen a connection like that since Jameis Winston and any linebacker ever. Overstreet drops back, and the little fellow snuck behind the linebackers. They looked right over his short ass. Middle Tennessee down 3. Beat My Meat Overstreet was benched. Some around campus are calling the gunslinger the Black Brett Favre for his ability to throw it to the defense and to throw a red rocket. Glassbones Jones with the catch. This team looks defeated already. This team came out with their heads in their hands. They just simply did not want to win this football game. Middle Tennessee loses the Fiesta Bowl 33-28. Sonny was reading a Home Depot magazine the entire game in protest of the BCS.
Coach Wrinkler, Tennessee Time here. How are you feeling after losing back-to-back games?
Well, not good. What the fuck am I supposed to say to that? Next question.
Coach, over here, Washington Post. You're losing Overstreet, white-ass Tim Atkins, Dirk Diggler, William Cheeks, and Sonny Wrinkler Jr. to graduation. How are you looking to replace?
Some of those guys are big players. I mean, you could just never replace. All-time players. The lefty needs to step up big time for sure.
Nebraska star, how does it feel to suck ass?
God damn it, someone get this guy out of here.
Hey, Sonny, New York Times. I have inside reports saying that you have got offered the LSU head coaching job. Will you be accepting that offer?
I appreciated the offer, but I will be staying and trying to bring Middle Tennessee another one of these to the 2018 National Championship. Also, I've accepted the head coaching job for the basketball team at Middle Tennessee State as well.
Play Kansas tonight.
Wait, what?
Don't overthink this. Look in my eye. Don't be scared. Don't be shy. Come on in. The water's fine. You say the ocean's rising like I give a shit.
If you shower with your clipboard, then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler!
Your 17th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders take on number 16 Penn State in the season opener. Up 14-3, the lefty gunslinger is able to find the new tight end, No Consent Trent, who Bill Crosby's the DB, and is able to walk into the end zone without anyone's permission. Handoff is to Wayne the Orphan, who has some space, and he puts that man in a blender! His parents would be so proud! Ah, fuck. African-American Brett Favre drops back and delivers a red rocket to No Consent Trent, Middle Tennessee up 35-17. This play was drawn up for the Oompa Loompa as he sneaks undetected behind the linebackers, and the 5'5" speedy sophomore is able to find the end zone. Looking for the 60-burger, Glassbones Jones is open, great ball! Oh, welcome to the spin cycle! So unexpected from Glassbones. With 80 on the line, No Consent Trent does his best Sandusky impression, penetrating the young secondary. This game was as messy as Penn State's locker room, 86-52. If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma, then you must be head coach. Sunday, Winkler! The 12th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are hosting the TCU Horned Frogs in the home opener. Down 7, the African-American Brett Favre slings one over the middle to Can't Swim Fisher, who is wearing a life jacket as he is deathly afraid of water but is still able to score. Handoff is to the Oompa Loompa, who takes his tiny legs to make this a one-score football game. Down 17, Sonny is going to need a miracle, and this miracle is going to come in the form of Glassbones Jones, as he's going to take this 75 yards for the score. How is this man still healthy? He has an injury rating of 1. A light breeze should take him out. The pitch is to the Oompa Loompa, who is so short that even Chris Yates slid into his DMs. Another pitch play. You don't like it? Stop it. And Brady scores to take the lead. It's all up to the defense. The defensive coordinator was executed at the 50-yard line for giving up the game-losing touchdown. Middle Tennessee 42, TCU 45.
Sonny, ESPN here. You lost your conference opener. What's the game plan moving forward?
Win. Next question.
NBC Sports, what cost you this game?
We're on to Texas Tech.
But coach!
I said we're on to Texas Tech.
Jerry from the Tennessee paper here. Your offensive line looked small out there, coach. What are you going to do to beef them up?
I don't know, Jerry. Does your mom want to play left guard? I'm sure that'll help. You know what? I'm done. Fuck this.
If you've fallen and can't get up, then you must be head coach. Sonny, Rickler. It's Blue Raiders versus Red Raiders in an all-time matchup. Down 14 early. The goal line triple option springs the orphan loose, who is able to go up and over the top. I haven't seen his emotions that high since his parents were alive. Red Raiders up 24-7. This is getting ugly. I can't watch. What happened? I can't see. With the defense not being able to stop a paper bag, these offensive touchdowns seem useless. Is Sonny on the hot seat? Huh? Right before half, Georgia transfer Payday Ray holds onto a red rocket. Middle Tennessee down 10. Handoff is to the orphan. No Consent Trent. Put that DB into the ground like the orphan's parents. He's going to take it to the house. This is a one-score football game. Can Sonny come from behind? It's his favorite position. Wayne the Orphan puts the team on his back on the 16th anniversary of his parents dying. Don't worry, we baked him a cake. Middle Tennessee on top. Up 5, 9 seconds left with the ball. It's 4th and 9. A score here would close the door. The lefty drops back. The pocket is collapsing. Surprise, pass missile, and this game is over. Middle Tennessee avoids the upset. Blue Raiders are indeed better than Red Raiders, 58-45. If you already pay your players, so you're not worried about name, image, and likeness, then you must be head coach. Sonny Rickler. It's a revenge game as Middle Tennessee lost to Texas last year in the Big 12 title. Down 10 already, son of a bitch! Why are we always behind? I miss the old days. Chris Yates, piss missiles. Great, the Oompa Loompa score. It doesn't really matter since our defense surrenders quicker than France. Pitches to the orphan, and Middle Tennessee has the lead, but not for long. Down 10, the lefty has been benched, and Hold My Balls McCall slings his balls into the end zone for a touchdown. Wait, what? Handoff is to the only player who can't ride all the rides at Disneyland. Middle Tennessee down 3 in Austin. Everybody tell their mothers as Middle Tennessee is on upset alert down 10 headed into the fourth quarter. Hold My Balls McCall is able to find the backup tight end Luke. I have feelings for Payday Gray. Middle Tennessee takes the lead late in the fourth. The defense got ran through quicker than Riley Reed. Middle Tennessee down 3. 12 seconds left in the game. Everybody and their grandmothers know what play is coming. The goal line triple option. But can they stop it? The handoff is to Brody. They can't see him behind the offensive line. Middle Tennessee scores with 9 seconds left. This game's over. Sonny steals one in Austin. 49-45.
Man, you ain't even had to do me like that, pimp. You ain't even had to do me like...
Hey, this man just...
I don't want to do this no more.
What?
If you also banged Rachel Nichols, then you must be head coach. Sonny Rickler! The 14th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are taking on Navy in the Georgia Dome because why not?
Goal line triple option springs the orphan for the score. He was unable to attend the pizza party because his parents didn't sign the permission slip. Down 10. Lefty hits the wide receiver who has worse knees than Derrick Rose, but with his touchdown brings Middle Tennessee within 3. Hand off to the orphan, who is able to score his second touchdown of the game, the same amount of parents that he doesn't have. Middle Tennessee takes the lead. Goal line triple option again. Don't like it? Stop it! Pitches to Jasper White. Who? He puts one in a blender! He's got a lane! He shrugs off another for a touchdown. That's Jasper White, ladies and gentlemen. The lefty drops back and dumps it off to the orphan. He cuts the sideline, gets a block! The orphan with the hat trick! 3 touchdowns for the parentless wonder. Only up 3. In the 4th, a missile is fired to Payday Ray, and he's off to the races! That's SEC speed, baby! The Georgia transfer takes it all the way to the house to ice this game. It's over! Sonny Wrinkler has beached the Navy. 63-45. You promised your parole officer you wouldn't go back to West Virginia? Then you must be head coach. Sonny Wrinkler! Your 12th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are taking on West Virginia and their country roads. Down 3. The African-American Brett Favre fires a red rocket! 53 yards downfield to Can't Swim Fisher.
Wait, why is he wearing a life jacket?
The lefty's looking for another one. This one looks ill-advised. He's double covered. And Lord, it's back-to-back bombs. I'm sure this is giving Japan World War II flashbacks. This punt is higher than Wiz Khalifa in 2012. Jasper White catches it running backwards. He makes one miss. He makes the cut towards the sideline. This white kid has run from the cop speed. He's running down the sideline. He's at the 50. He makes the cut back at the 40. He bounces off a tackler at the 30. He's going to take it 94 yards for a touchdown. It's a house call from Jasper White. Looking for the 50 burger. The lefty drops his third bomb of the game. This man sure ate his Wheaties today. Goddamn. A garbage time touchdown to no consent Trent lifts Middle Tennessee over the 70 burger. Sonny Wrinkler rips up those country roads. 71-43.
Well, I don't really want to argue with Gandalf, and we're not going to run the ball, so we're going to go ahead and fold the Big 12 immediately, and we're just going to send TCU down to Division 2.
If you've missed 5 weeks due to a quadruple bypass, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
We are at Soldier Field for part 9 of this storied rivalry between number 8 Oklahoma and the second-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders. On the opening drive, Hold My Balls McCall shows how big his balls really are, slinging the ball into a tight window to no consent Trent. Looking to extend their lead to 14. The pocket is collapsing. He finds Glass Bones Jones for the score. I feel like he's been here since Vietnam. Wait a second. No, it can't be. It's been so long. It's the goal line triple option. The pitch is to the orphan. He's got space. He's got one man to beat. He hits him with a stiffy. Get the fuck off me, you baby back bitch. With Oklahoma clawing back, Middle Tennessee goes to 5 wide, and they leave no consent Trent one-on-one. What a fucking mistake as he enters the end zone like he enters his girlfriend without permission. Wait, what? Middle Tennessee puts away the Sooners 51-45 and advance to take on Texas in the Big 12 title game. If you thought Horns Down was just a depressing strip club, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
It's the Big 12 title game as Sonny Wrinkler attempts to achieve his final Power 5 conference title to complete his Infinity Gauntlet. The Blue Raiders' opening drive ends with a naked bootleg from Hold My Balls McCall.
That sounds like a video I watched last night.
The Longhorns are about to tie this game up as the Middle Tennessee defense is softer than cream cheese. It's going the other way! Chance Townsend jumped the route. He's got more green grass ahead of him than Cheech and Chong. He's at their own 40, the 50, the 40, the 30, the 20. He's going to go all the way. Chance Townsend, touchdown. Middle Tennessee up 14. Jasper the Casper White with the return. He's got room ahead of him. He cuts to the left. He's going to have to break at least one tackle. He's going to have to go out of bounds here. No! He puts the Longhorn team in a blender. They're so lost, they're going to need a map. Somebody better call Meredith Gray because this is a house call. Up 4. Looking to strike before half. Hold My Balls McCall rolls out. The safety bites up. It's Can't Swim Fisher. He's all alone. Somebody get a lifeguard. An easy pitch and catch for the score. 2 minutes left in the 4th. With a 7-point lead. Middle Tennessee 5 wide. McCall pump fakes and fires a dagger to no consent Trent to put this game out of reach. That's gonna do it. Middle Tennessee has beaten the Texas Longhorns 43-28. The coaches shake hands at midfield as Sonny tells him great game and he's gonna fuck his wife. And there it is. Sonny has now won the Big Ten, the ACC, the SEC, the Pac-12, and finally the Big 12 Conference. The gauntlet is complete. Middle Tennessee and the Blue Raiders will face off against Florida State in the BCS title. If you're about to drive the Seminoles off their land again, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
It's first-ranked Florida State taking on your second-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders for the BCS national title game. Florida State's first play of the game, and according to their game plan, they're going to the air.
Quarterback has enough time to watch two episodes of 60 Minutes. He fires a rocket. That's picked off! It's Jade Edwards going the opposite direction. Florida State's quarterbacks are doing a great Zach Wilson impression. 4th and 8 for the Blue Raiders. Sonny doesn't believe in field goals. They find Bollywood Brown over the middle to tie up this game. 1 second left in the half. One opportunity to seize everything we've ever wanted. Payday Ray with a slant, and he climbs the ladder! We're going into halftime, knotted up at 28, down 3, and needing to score early in the 4th. Nobody's open! He tosses up a prayer! The 5'5" running back comes down with it! Middle Tennessee is in trouble, down 11, 3 minutes left in the game. Hold my balls, McCall, hits him with the pump fake, and Can't Swim Fisher is behind the defense! It's gonna be a touchdown! It's a one-score ball game! This is it. One last play for the BCS National Championship. Touchdown wins it. Looks like it's the goal line triple option. Hold my balls, McCall keeps it, and it's gonna win! Middle Tennessee 55, Florida State 52, the final 50 burger of the season. Ladies and gentlemen, Sonny Wrinkler and the Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders are your national champions for the second time in 3 years. Dynasty? Sonny Wrinkler will speak to the press on Wednesday about the future of the Middle Tennessee State program.
We now take you live to NCAA President Mark Emmert. Wait a second, we're losing the feed here.
I am
Sonny Wrinkler.
It appears as Sonny Wrinkler has used his Infinity Gauntlet to create a super conference, split into two divisions, the Sonny Division and the Wrinkler Division. The Sonny Division includes Alabama, Auburn, Clemson, Notre Dame, Ohio State, Texas A&M, UCF, and the Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders. The Wrinkler Division contains Cincinnati, Florida, Florida State, Georgia, Georgia Tech, Michigan, Oklahoma, and USC.
If you have to take a nap before breakfast, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
Your second-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders host the Georgia Bulldogs for the season opener. 4th and goal, down 3. The orphan is able to find the hole in his heart that was placed there by the brutal murder of his parents. Touchdown, Blue Raiders! With the defense giving away points, Hold My Balls McCall is forced to drop back and let it fly! And it's caught by the fullback Dustin Scott! What is he doing? Down 4 points, hitting them with the NASCAR package. The Blue Raiders get set quickly, and they pitch it to the orphan, who finds the edge, and with his second touchdown is definitely getting laid tonight. Trying to go up 2 scores, Hold My Balls McCall is scanning the field, fires it to Sterile Darryl, the man who only fires blanks. Goal line package in the game. It's a run. No, play action. Tight end has a step. It's intercepted. A 4th quarter interception by Hold My Balls McCall as the turnovers continue. Sonny Wrinkler has pulled an Andy Reid and has ran the clock out on himself. This game is over. Middle Tennessee is upset in week 1. Middle Tennessee 36, Georgia 40.
If you thought Idaho was a fictional place, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Wrinkler!
The 0-1 ninth-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders visit 20th-ranked Boise State for a battle on the Smurf Turf. On the opening drive, Hold My Balls McCall has dragged the offense down the field with his balls, of course, and he's gonna finish it off with the trademarked goal line triple option to Jasper the Casper White. Just outside of the red zone, it's 3rd and 7. Bollywood Brown is open on a slant. Let's listen to Coach Wrinkler, who is mic'd up.
Bollywood Brown! Surfing the bodies into the end zone!
You can see that Coach is fired up. Definitely had his Denny's today. Hold My Balls McCall at the line. He sees something he likes. He points to Payday Ray. Here's the snap. The safety's more confused than Joe Biden trying to form a sentence. Touchdown, Blue Raiders! A 50-yard bomb! Middle Tennessee on top, 21-6. In the red zone once more. Plenty of time in the pocket. Rears back and zips a ball buster to Bollywood Brown for his second score. With the defense showing 3 down linemen, look for Sonny to shove it down their throat respectfully, and the orphan is loose! We'd reach out to his emergency contacts, but he doesn't have any! Touchdown! With Hold My Balls McCall out for 2 weeks with a stress fracture, freshman quarterback Chad Chatson comes into the game and fires a Jaeger bomb for the 50-burger! Ladies and gentlemen, this is a Sonny Wrinkler blowout! Looking for one more score. Chad Chatson is in trouble, rolls out to the right, sets his feet, and delivers a fastball to Sterile Darryl! That one had some heat on it! Middle Tennessee takes the Broncos to the shed out back, 78-46.
If you tried to recruit Thanos to play linebacker, then you must be head coach.
Sonny Rickler!
Your 5th-ranked Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders travel across country to take on the 21st-ranked Washington Huskies. 4th and goal, down 3. Chad Chadson's already thrown 2 interceptions and shotgun 3 Keystone Lights. He takes a snap, he scans the field, and squeezes a Jaeger bomb in between 2 linebackers. Middle Tennessee on top 14-10. Chad Chadson has been suspended for hitting a bong on the sidelines. Sonny had to grab equipment manager Terrence Hollis to play quarterback. Don't even be able to throw to hand it off to the orphan. He makes 1 miss, then 2. Just the amount of parents that he's missing. Touchdown, Blue Raiders! They're gonna let the equipment manager throw. Oh dear God! He lobs up a duck! But Sterile Darrell goes up and gets it for the score. Middle Tennessee up 2 scores. Terrence Hollis took 1 hit and fractured every bone below his waist. Without any options, Sonny had to bring in emergency quarterback, fullback Dustin Scott. He rolls out of the pocket, sets his feet, sidearms the ball to Bollywood Brown. That's going to put it out of reach. Sonny sent the Huskies back to Siberia, 43-26.
We now lay to rest a son, a father, a former collegiate athlete, Christopher Rice. He was 37 years old.
Yes! I never hit the under!
What?
Line was 39.5. Oh, shut up, Steve! Just because he had the over doesn't make you a good guy!
If you haven't seen your feet in over 5 years, then you must be head coach. Sonny! Rickler! It's pouring down rain for part 10 of the Middle Tennessee-Oklahoma rivalry in a top 15 matchup. 3rd and a mile on the opening drive. Play action to the orphan. Chad Chadson thinks he's got something. Heaves up a Jaeger bomb. And Bollywood Brown gets a foot down in the back of the end zone. First play for the Sooners. Sonny is bringing the house like always. Quarterback is hit as he's thrown. And it's picked off. Going the other way. The man with the biggest neck roll in the nation is going to take this back to the house. Tied up 14 after the defense got the Riley Reed treatment. Uh-oh, it's a goal line triple option. The orphan takes it between the tackles and gets met at the goal line. Not by his parents, though. Touchdown, Blue Raiders. Trying to establish the run game. The orphan hits the edge. Oh, that man was more lost than the FBI looking for Brian Laundrie. The parentless Heisman frontrunner is going to go all the way. This is a Sonny Rinkler shootout. Down 7 with 1 minute left in the game. Chad Chadson trying to sober up. Fakes a handoff and he slings it to Bollywood Brown. This game is tied up. Tick, 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 trying to win the game. It's a slam pattern. It's Darryl. Oh, but the defense is shooting blanks. Touchdown, Blue Raiders. Sonny hijacks the Sooner Schooner. 50-42.
We, the jury, in the above entitled action, find the defendant, Orenthal James Simpson, not guilty of...
What? The money line on guilty was the lock of the century. They had blood in his car. He ran away.
Well, that's a bad beat. I'm sorry about your daughter.
Thank you for calling 1-800-GAMBLER. How can I help you today?
Hi, yes. Can I ask you guys a question?
Yes, absolutely, sir. We are here to help.
Yeah, do you guys think Cleveland will cover the spread at home against the Cardinals?
Sir, this line is for people with a problem.
Yes, and my problem is I don't know if Arizona can go into Cleveland and take care of business.
Sir, this conversation is over.
Are you telling me to smash the over? Done. 15 units. Thanks, man. God, my kid sucks.